BGMC. The biblical truth lives here.
Scriptures foretold of the Anointed One, Yeshua HaMashiach. The Messiah Yeshua came to call the people back to the truth of His Word and to follow that righteous path. Yeshua then called Jewish men to be His disciples, and after His death and resurrection, those Jewish men told the world about the Jewish Messiah. Now, after 2,000 years, Beth Goyim Messianic Congregation has that same calling of those Jewish men, telling all people, both Jew and Gentile, about the proper ancient path, teaching the Route 66 King's Highway from Genesis through to Revelation, and how you need and can get back to the proper roots of the faith and a closer walk with God. Now, let's hear the message.
Let's go get a blessing. Turn to the book of Romans, chapter 6, please.
Vamos al libro de Romanos, capítulo 6.
Romans, chapter 6, please.
Romanos, capítulo 6.
Verse 4.
Verso 4.
This message is a 582nd taped message.
Este es el mensaje 582.
It's called Walking in the New Life.
Se titula Caminando en la Nueva Vida.
Walking in the New Life.
Caminando en la nueva vida.
This message will, everything you hear today,
todo lo que escuchen el día de hoy,
for those who are new, will be in English and in Spanish.
Para aquellos que son nuevos, el mensaje será en inglés y español.
The message will have a synopsis.
El mensaje tendrá sinopsis.
And two main themes.
Y dos temas principales.
Okay, I will read the scriptures in English only.
Voy a leer las escrituras en inglés nada más.
And if you are reading in Spanish, please read ahead.
Y si las estás leyendo en español, por favor, léelas conmigo.
If we were to read both languages of the scriptures,
porque si leyéramos las escrituras en los dos lenguajes,
the message would easily be 5 hours long.
El mensaje fácilmente tendría 5 horas de duración.
Romans chapter 6.
Romanos capítulo 6.
Verse 4.
Verso 4.
Okay. Synopsis. What we are going to look at today in this teaching is what does it mean to have a new life? What does it mean to leave the old life behind? What does it mean to go through immersion of 3,000 feet of water? What does it mean to come to the other side of the river? To look back and see those who wanted you dead, dead. What do you do with this newfound freedom? Do you sin more to make the death of those people worthless? Do you leave Egypt? But Egypt does not leave you.
Synopsis. Lo que vamos a ver hoy en esta enseñanza es qué significa tener una nueva vida. ¿Qué significa dejar atrás la vieja vida? ¿Qué significa pasar por la inmersión de 3,000 pies de agua? ¿Qué significa llegar al otro lado del río? ¿Mirar hacia atrás y ver muertos a los que querían verlo muerto? ¿Qué hace usted con esta nueva libertad? ¿Peca usted más para hacer que la muerte de esas personas no tenga valor? ¿Deja usted Egipto? Pero Egipto no lo dejó.
Okay, now we look at our foundation scripture, Romans chapter 6, verse 4.
Nuestra escritura de fundición es Romanos 6, 4.
Through immersion into his death, we were buried with him. So that just as through the glory of the Father, the Messiah was raised from the dead, likewise we too might live a new life. Key word for this message is new life.
Escritura fundacional, Romanos 6, 4. A través de la inmersión en su muerte fuimos sepultados con él, por lo que al igual que, por medio de la gloria del Padre, el Mesías fue resucitado de entre los muertos a sí mismo, también nosotros podamos vivir una vida nueva. Palabra clave, nueva vida.
Theme number one is called immersion, death, glory, new life. Romans 6, verse 1 through 4, immersion into a new life. Shemot, Exodus chapter 14, verse 10 through 29, immersion into the dry sea, but death in the sea to those who don't change their lives. Romans 6, verse 4, Shemot, Exodus chapter 14, verse 22 and 23.
Tema 1, inmersión, muerte, gloria, vida nueva. Romanos 6, 1 al 4. Inmersión a una nueva vida. Shemot 14:10-29, inmersión en el mar seco, pero la muerte en el mar para aquellos que no cambian sus vidas. Romanos 6:4, Shemot, Éxodo 14:22-23.
Theme number 2 is called Leaving the Old Life Behind in Spirit and in Truth. Romans 6, verse 1 through 4, merging into new life. Key verse, Shemot, Exodus 32, verse 4. Shemot, Exodus 32, verse 1 through 25. They left Egypt, but Egypt didn't leave them. Romans 6, verse 1 and 2. Romans 1, verse 22 to 24. Luke chapter 9, verse 57 through 62. Do you look back? Bereshit, Genesis chapter 19, verse 17 through 26. Given order, but failure leads to death. Philippians chapter 3, verse 12 through 14. Pursuing the goal. And 1 Corinthians 9, verse 24 to 27. Run the race.
Tema número 2. Dejar atrás la vieja vida en espíritu y verdad. Romanos 6, 1, 4. Inmersión a una nueva vida. Verso clave, Shemot 32, 4. Shemot 32, 1, 25. Salieron de Egipto, pero Egipto no los dejó. Romanos 6, 1. Romanos 1, 22, 24. Lucas 9, 57, 62. Mira usted hacia atrás. Bereshit, Génesis 19, 17, 26. Determinando orden, pero el fracaso conduce a la muerte. Filipenses 3, 12, 14. Alcanzando el objetivo. Primera de Corintios 9, 24, 27. Correr la carrera.
Amen. Let's go to theme number 1.
Vamos al tema número 1.
Immersion, death, glory, new life.
Inmersión, muerte, gloria y nueva vida.
Romans chapter 6, please.
Romanos capítulo 6.
Verse 1 through 4.
Versos 1 al 4.
This part is called immersion into a new life.
Este tema se titula Inmersión en una nueva vida.
So then, are we to say, let's keep on sinning so that there can be more grace? Heaven forbid. How can we who have died to sin still live in it? Don't you know that those of us who have been immersed into Messiah Yeshua have been immersed into his death? Though immersion into his death, we were buried with him. So just as through the glory of the Father, the Messiah was raised from the dead, likewise we too might live a new life. Amen?
Amen.
Let's go back to verse 4, please.
Veamos el verso 4.
Verse 4, this is our key verse for the whole message.
Verso 4, el verso clave para todo el mensaje.
Through immersion into his death, we were buried with him, so that just as through the glory of the Father, the Messiah was raised from the dead, likewise we too might have a new life. Amen?
Amen.
Amen?
Amen.
All right, what we're going to do today,
lo que vamos a hacer el día de hoy,
is we're starting with verse 4.
Es que comenzaremos con el verso 4.
Remember when this was written.
Recuerda cuando esto fue escrito.
People didn't have computers.
La gente no tenía computadoras.
People didn't have copiers.
La gente no tenía copiadoras.
And those of us are a little older, they didn't even have those mimeograph machines.
Y aquellos que somos mayores no tenían ni los mimeográficos.
Those ditto machines, they used to call them ditto machines in America.
Las máquinas ditto, ¿qué dice?
So when you wrote a letter.
Cuando tú escribes una carta.
You chose your words very carefully.
Tú escogías las palabras cuidadosamente.
And each of the words is very strongly worded.
Y cada una de las palabras son deletreadas fuertemente.
Okay. Now, remember, Paul's a rabbi.
Recuerda que Pablo es un rabino.
He teaches like a rabbi.
Él enseña como un rabino.
And this letter that he's sending to the Roman Messianic congregation.
Y esta carta que está enviando a la congregación mesiánica romana.
Is not for the general population.
No es para el público en general.
It is for the leadership.
Es para el liderazgo.
And the letters are specific.
Y las cartas son específicas.
To those who have already been trained in the Torah.
Para aquellos que ya han sido entrenados en el Torah.
And those who do not follow the Torah.
Y aquellos que no siguen la Torah.
Will not understand what Paul is writing.
No van a entender lo que Pablo está escribiendo.
To the Messianic congregation in Rome.
A la congregación mesiánica en Roma.
And you know this once we get to verse 6.
Y tú sabes esto cuando estamos en el verso 6.
That you need to understand the Torah.
Que necesitas entender la Torah.
And keep the holy days.
Y guardar los días santos.
To understand what is being written.
Para entender lo que está escrito.
Let's look back at now at verse 4.
Veamos ahora el verso 4.
Through immersion into his death, we were buried with him, so just as through the glory of the Father, the Messiah was raised from the dead, likewise, we too might live a new life. Amen?
Amen.
So what we have to do is look at this.
Lo que tenemos que hacer es mirar a esto.
You young people, like Kathy, Tiffany, and Danny, and Ariel.
Jovencitos.
You should all have a notebook.
Todos ustedes deberían tener un cuaderno de notas.
What's going to happen?
Porque sabes qué es lo que va a pasar.
I'm going to ask you questions.
Yo voy a hacerte preguntas.
Even you, Miss Gigi and Frank.
Incluso ustedes, otros jovencitos.
And those adults.
Y aquellos adultos.
You should be taking notes.
Deberían estar tomando notas.
Key words to verse 4, Mr. Barbero.
Palabras clave para las el mensaje.
The first word, the key word is immersion.
La palabra clave es inmersión.
Immersion.
Inmersión.
Second key word.
Segunda palabra clave.
Is the word death.
Esa palabra muerte.
Second key word is death.
Segunda palabra clave es muerte.
Why is immersion and death in the same sentence?
¿Por qué la inmersión y la muerte están en la misma oración?
Another key word in this sentence.
Otro verso clave en la oración.
Is a phrase that says glory of the Father.
Es una frase que dice la gloria del Padre.
Glory of the Father.
Gloria del Padre.
And then finally,
y finalmente,
the fourth thing we want to look at in this one sentence.
La cuarta cosa que queremos ver en esta oración
is the phrase live a new life.
Es la frase vivir una nueva vida.
And let me do those four words again.
Déjame hacer esas cuatro palabras.
Immersion.
Inmersión.
Death.
Muerte.
Glory of the Father.
Gloria del Padre.
And live a new life.
Y vivir una nueva vida.
We're going to be talking about these four subjects today.
Vamos a estar hablando de estos cuatro temas hoy.
All of these four words.
Todas estas cuatro palabras.
Speak of us leaving Egypt.
Hablan de nosotros dejando Egipto.
Okay? All of these words.
Todas estas palabras.
Speak of us leaving Egypt.
Hablan de nosotros dejando Egipto.
You said I've never heard that before.
Tú quizá dirás nunca he escuchado eso
well,
antes.
Welcome to Beth Goim.
Bienvenidos a Beth Goim.
And we're going to show you how to read your Bible.
Y te vamos a mostrar cómo leer la Biblia.
I've been reading the Bible for 30 years.
He estado leyendo la Biblia por 30 años.
No, you haven't.
No, tú no lo has hecho.
You think you've been reading it.
Tú crees que lo has estado leyendo.
And I'll prove it through the Word of God in a few minutes.
Por medio de la palabra de Dios en unos minutos.
And don't think this is arrogance.
Y no pienses que es arrogancia.
It's not arrogance.
No es arrogancia.
This is my family's book.
Es el libro de mi familia.
This is what's called love.
Es lo que se llama amor.
And knowing your father's word.
Y conocer la palabra de tu padre.
Okay? So these words are all talking about Pesach.
Estas palabras todas están hablando de la Pascua.
Hagmatzah.
Hagmatzah.
Bikurim.
Bikurim.
Okay, so that's Passover.
Es la Pascua.
Feast of Unleavened Bread.
La fiesta de los panes sin levadura.
And first fruits.
Y primeros frutos.
These four words talk about us leaving Egypt.
Estas cuatro palabras hablan de nosotros cuando dejamos Egipto.
Okay, to begin a new life.
Para comenzar una nueva vida.
See, we just completed the week of Hag Matzah.
Hemos completado la semana de Hag Matzah.
So picture this time frame.
Imagínate esta línea de tiempo.
We had Passover last week.
Tuvimos la Pascua la semana pasada.
Then we entered into the first day of Hag Matzah.
Entonces entramos en el primer día de Hag Matzah.
What is so important about the first day of Hag Matzah?
¿Qué es tan importante del primer día de Hag Matzah?
To those who follow God's word.
Para aquellos que siguen la palabra de
it's
Dios.
It's the day we left bondage after 430 years.
Es el día que dejamos de esclavitud después de 430 años.
What is so important about the feast of Hag Matzah?
¿Qué es tan importante de la fiesta de Hag Matzah?
It's the day we were immersed into God's way of living.
Es el momento en que fuimos sumergidos en la palabra viviente del Señor.
Because what happened?
Porque ¿qué pasó?
We left Egypt.
Dejamos Egipto.
And then we came to the Red Sea.
Y vinimos al mar de los juncos,
it's
o rojo.
Not red. It's
no
not
es
the
rojo.
Red Sea.
No es el mar rojo.
In the Hebrew, it's reed.
En hebreo es reed o
it's
juncos.
Not red. It's reed.
Es de los juncos.
Okay. It's the Red Sea.
Es el mar de los juncos.
God split the Red Sea.
Dios dividió el mar de los juncos.
We walked to the other side.
Caminamos hacia el otro lugar.
The Egyptians chased us.
Los egipcios nos persiguieron.
And we got to the other side of the river.
Y llegamos al otro lado del río.
And then we left the old life behind.
Y dejamos la vida antigua atrás.
We left the old life behind.
La vida antigua atrás.
Look at verse 4 again, please.
Veamos al verso 4.
Through immersion into his death, we were buried with him. So just as through the glory of the Father, the Messiah was raised from the dead, likewise we too might live a new life. Amen?
Amen.
Immersion speaks of the days following Hag Matzah.
Inmersión habla de los días que siguen después de Hag Matzah.
Anytime you're seeing this immersion,
cada vez que veas esta inmersión,
especially if it's tied together with death,
especialmente si se relaciona con la muerte.
Because when was Yeshua immersed?
Porque cuando es que fue Yeshua sumergido?
He wasn't immersed during Passover, right?
Él no fue sumergido durante la Pascua.
He went another time of the year to get immersed by his cousin Yochanan, right?
Él fue en otro tiempo del año que fue sumergido por su primo Yochanan.
So here we're talking about immersion and death.
Aquí estamos hablando de inmersión y muerte.
When did immersion and death happen?
Cuando la inmersión y la muerte sucedió.
During the feast of Hag Matzah.
Durante la fiesta de Hag Matzah.
600 chariots were following Israel.
600 caballos con sus carros estaban siguiendo a Israel.
Pharaoh had let the slaves go.
El faraón liberó a los esclavos.
And now he changed his mind, right?
Y ahora él cambió su decisión.
And we walked through the water.
Y caminamos en el agua.
On dry ground.
En tierra seca.
And Pharaoh came chasing us, right?
Y el faraón nos estaba persiguiendo.
And what happened to the Egyptians?
¿Y qué pasó con los egipcios?
What happened to the Egyptians?
¿Qué pasó con los egipcios?
The Lord caused them to die.
El Señor les causó la muerte.
So in the beginning of verse 4,
en el comienzo del verso 4,
if you have a Hebrew mind,
si tienes una mente hebrea,
you're thinking immersion,
estás pensando en inmersión,
and death,
y la muerte.
When do we have immersion and death put together?
¿Cuándo tenemos la inmersión y la muerte puestas juntas?
During the feast of Hag Matzah.
Durante la fiesta de Hag Matzah.
Now hold your place here. In Romans 6.
Mantengan su lugar en Romanos 6.
We're going to look at another scripture.
Y vamos a observar otra escritura.
We're going to look at a community immersion.
Vamos a ver a una inmersión comunal.
And tremendous depth that's involved in it.
Y en una profundidad que está envuelta en esto.
Okay, turn to Exodus chapter 14, please.
Vámonos a Éxodo 14.
Exodus 14.
Éxodo 14.
Verse 10. Through 29.
Verso 10 al 29.
This section is called.
Esta sección se titula.
Immersion into the dry sea, but death in the sea to those who don't change their lives.
Inmersión en el mar seco, pero la muerte en el mar para aquellos que no cambian sus vidas.
Shemot, Exodus chapter 14.
Shemot, Éxodo 14.
Verse 10 through 29.
Verso 10 al 29.
We're going to look at our key verses first.
Vamos a ver a nuestros versos claves primero.
Key verses first.
Verso clave primero.
Verse 28 and 29 first.
Verso 28 y 29 primero.
The water came back and covered all the chariots and cavalry of Pharaoh's army who had followed them into the sea. Not even one of them was left. But the people of Israel walked on dry ground in the sea, with the water walled up for them on the right and on their left. Amen?
Amen.
Now in verse 28,
en el verso 28,
it said, Pharaoh's army followed Israel into the sea.
Dice que la caballería del faraón siguió a los israelitas hacia el mar.
But in verse 29,
pero en el verso 29,
it says, we walked on dry ground.
Dice que caminamos en tierra seca.
It seems like there's a contradiction.
Parece como que fuera una contradicción.
Right? You know, we're... The sea has water, right, Frank?
El mar tiene agua.
You know, that's generally what an ocean has, water.
Eso es generalmente lo que tiene un océano,
you know, there
agua.
Was a guy who sang a song.
Tener al hombre que canta la canción.
From the group Talking Heads.
Del grupo Cabezas que Hablan.
Okay? And he said, there's water at the bottom of the ocean.
Dice, hay agua en el fondo del océano.
Same as it ever was.
Lo mismo como siempre fue.
Same as it ever was.
Siempre ha sido así.
So there's water in the ocean, right?
Había agua en el océano.
There's waters in the river, right, David?
Hay aguas en los ríos.
That's what makes it a river, right?
Eso es lo que le hace un río.
Because if it doesn't have water, it's not a river, right?
Porque si no tiene agua, no es un río.
So was God having a senior moment here?
¿Está teniendo Dios un momento de vejez aquí?
There seems to be a contradiction.
Parece que hay una contradicción.
They're following us into the sea.
Nos están siguiendo al mar.
But we're walking on dry ground.
Pero estamos caminando en tierra seca.
I see it too, man.
Yo también lo veo.
I see the pink elephants with balloons.
Yo veo los elefantes rosados.
Do you see them too, Carmen?
¿Los ves tú también?
Here, have some.
Toma uno.
Okay, let's read the whole passage.
Leamos el pasaje completo.
Let's read verse 10 through 29.
Leamos los versos 10 al 29.
And then we'll take a closer look at the
y
verses.
Y después veremos detalladamente.
Verse 10 through 29, please.
Versos 10 al 29.
As Pharaoh approached, the people of Israel looked up and saw the Egyptians right there, coming after them. In great fear, the people of Israel cried out to Jehovah and said to Moshe, was it because there weren't enough graves in Egypt that you brought us out to die in the desert? Why have you done this to us, bringing us out of Egypt? Didn't we tell you in Egypt to leave us alone? We just go on being slaves for the Egyptians. It would be better for us to be Egyptian slaves than it's to die in the desert. Moshe answered the people, stop being so fearful. Remain steady, and you will see how Jehovah is going to save you. He will do today. Today you have seen the Egyptians, but you will never see them again. Jehovah will do battle for you. Just calm yourselves down. Jehovah asked Moshe, why are you crying to me? Tell the people of Israel, go forward. Lift your staff. Reach out with your hand over the sea and divide it in two. The people of Israel will advance into the sea on dry ground. As for me, I will make the Egyptians hard-hearted, and they will march in after them. Thus I will win glory for myself at the expense of Pharaoh and all his army, chariots, and cavalry. Then the Egyptians will realize that I am Jehovah, and I have won myself glory at the expense of Pharaoh, his chariots, and his cavalry. Next, the angel of Elohim, who was going ahead of the camp of Israel, moved away and went behind them. The column of cloud moved away from in front of them and stood behind them. It stationed itself between the camp of Egypt and the camp of Israel. There was a cloud and darkness here, but light and night there, so that the one did not come near the other all night long. Moshe reached out his hand over the sea, and Jehovah caused the sea to go back before a strong east wind all night. He made the sea become dry land, and its water was divided in two. Then the people of Israel went into the sea on dry ground with the water walled up for them on their right and on their left. The Egyptians continued their pursuit, going after them into the sea. All the Pharaoh's horses, chariots, and cavalry. Just before dawn, Jehovah looked out, and the Egyptians' army threw the column of fire and cloud and threw them into a panic. He caused the wheels of the chariots to break off so that they would only move with difficulty. The Egyptians said, Jehovah is fighting for Israel against the Egyptians. Let's get away from them. Jehovah said to Moshe, reach out your hand over the sea and the water will return and cover the Egyptians with the chariots and the cavalry. Moshe reached out his hand out over the sea. And by dawn, the sea had returned to its former depth. The Egyptians tried to flee, but Jehovah swept them into the sea. The water came back and covered all the chariots and cavalry. Pharaoh's army would follow them into the sea. Not even one of them was left. But the people of Israel walked on dry ground in the sea, with the water walled up for them on their right and on their left. Amen?
Amen.
Pretty interesting passage, don't you think?
Un pasaje muy interesante, ¿no crees?
A dramatic reading.
Una lectura dramática.
Let's look now back at verse 13.
Vamos al verso 13.
You have to read the Bible dramatically.
Tienes que leer la Biblia dramáticamente.
It's the best novella there is.
Es la mejor novela que existe.
And the water came, but you got to read it.
Y el agua vino. Tienes que leerla.
Like, read verse 13 like you mean it.
Lee el verso 13 como
read it like you mean it.
Léelo como lo sientes.
Look at verse 13.
Verso 13.
Moshe answered the people, stop being so fearful. Remain steady, and you will see how Jehovah is going to save you. He will do today. Today you have seen the Egyptians, but you will never see them again. It wasn't Moshe answering the people.
No fue así como Moisés.
Stop being so fearful.
Dejen de temer.
Remain standing.
Manténganse firmes.
And you will see how Adonai is going to save you.
Y verán cómo Adonai los salvará.
He will do it.
Vamos a hacerlo.
Today.
Él lo hará hoy.
Today, I'm telling you today.
Hoy día te digo hoy.
Today you have seen the Egyptians for the
hoy
last
día
time.
Verás a los egipcios por último.
Come on! Okay, the guy was 80.
El hombre tenía 80
he was 80.
Años.
You know, but he still was strong.
Pero aún era fuerte.
He was still was strong.
Aún era fuerte.
So here, the people are leaving Egypt.
La gente se está yendo de Egipto aquí.
And you're changing your life.
Y estás cambiando tu vida.
But we lived in Egypt for 430 years.
Pero vivimos en Egipto por 430 años.
We only knew slavery.
Solamente conocíamos de la esclavitud.
We only knew slavery.
Solamente conocimos de la esclavitud.
We only knew pagan things.
Solamente conocimos cosas paganas.
Remember, we had the Egyptian gods all around us.
Recuerden que teníamos a los dioses egipcios
alrededor
de nosotros.
That's all we knew.
Eso es todo lo que conocimos.
The Bible wasn't written yet.
La Biblia no estaba escrita aún.
How blessed we are today.
Cuán bendecidos somos nosotros.
How blessed we are today.
Cuán bendecidos somos nosotros.
That you have a Bible.
Que tienes una Biblia.
How many people are blessed because of that?
¿Cuántos son bendecidos a causa de eso?
How many people have more than one Bible?
¿Cuántos? What?
How many people have more than one Bible?
¿Cuántas personas tienen más de una Biblia?
How many people have more than three Bibles?
¿Cuántas personas tienen más de tres Biblias?
How many people have more than five Bibles?
¿Cuántas personas tienen más de cinco Biblias?
Aren't we so blessed?
¿Por qué somos tan bendecidos?
But the people of Israel and the mixed multitude didn't.
Pero la gente de Egipto era I'm sorry.
The people of Israel and the mixed multitude.
La gente de Israel y la multitud mixta.
They didn't have a Bible.
No tenían una Biblia.
They had to learn how to trust God.
Tenían que aprender a confiar en Dios.
They were afraid.
Tenían miedo.
They were afraid.
Ellos tenían miedo.
This is why I believe we have the book of Revelation.
Por eso es que creo que tenemos el libro de Apocalipsis.
See, when it starts to happen,
para que cuando comience a suceder,
don't be afraid.
No temas.
Don't do the same thing that they did in the past.
No hagas lo mismo que ellos hicieron en el pasado.
Walk in a new way of life.
Camina en una nueva manera de vivir.
Now let's take a look at the people of Israel.
Veamos a la gente de Israel.
Let's take a look at this.
Tomemos un vistazo.
There were 10 plagues that happened to Egypt, right?
Hubieron 10 plagas que pasó en Egipto.
Could they check the news to see what was happening?
Podían ellos leer las noticias para saber qué pasaba.
Turn on their televisions.
Prender su televisión.
Check the 6 o'clock news.
Y mirar las noticias de las 6 de la tarde.
Yes, today in Egypt.
El día de hoy en Egipto.
Yes, hail fell from the sky.
Y granizo cayó del cielo.
And miraculously it turned to fire.
Y milagrosamente se tornó en fuego.
Now back to you, Bob.
Ahora de vuelta a ti.
They couldn't do that.
No podían hacer eso.
Telemundo.
Telemundo.
Yeah, come on, you know el fuego. Now back to the studio.
De vuelta al estudio.
They didn't have the news to check.
Ellos no tenían las noticias para escuchar.
So Israel was learning how to trust God.
Israel estuvo aprendiendo a confiar en el Señor.
They couldn't call their friends that lived in the other parts of Egypt.
No podían llamar a sus amigos que estaban en otros lugares de Egipto.
Hey, what's going on over there, Rosa?
Oye, ¿qué está pasando allá?
What's going on there, Betsy?
Dime qué pasa por allá, Betsy.
So here they're beginning to walk with God.
Aquí estaban comenzando a caminar con Dios.
They're beginning to walk with God.
En el comienzo de caminar con Dios.
And they're fearful.
Y tienen miedo.
They're learning how to trust.
Están aprendiendo cómo confiar.
Now Pharaoh was chasing them.
Ahora el faraón les estaba persiguiendo.
But they had to learn how to change their lives.
Pero tenían que aprender cómo cambiar sus vidas.
They're learning how to trust.
Estaban aprendiendo cómo confiar.
They had just experienced Pesach for the first time.
Experimentaron apenas su primera Pascua o Pesach.
We already know about it.
Nosotros ya sabemos de
We've eso. Experienced it many times.
Ya la hemos experimentado muchas veces.
But they
veces.
Had done that for the first time.
Pero ellos hicieron eso por primera vez.
They had put the blood on the door for the very first time.
Ellos pusieron la sangre en el portón por primera vez.
They had experienced Hag Matzah for the very first time.
Experimentaron Hag Matzah por primera vez.
Now they're leaving Egypt.
Ahora están dejando Egipto.
Now they're leaving Egypt.
Ahora están dejando Egipto.
And they're about to begin a new life.
Y están a punto de comenzar una nueva vida.
Today's message is all about beginning a new life walking with God.
El día de hoy se trata de comenzar una nueva vida siguiendo a Dios.
But something we have to learn from this.
Pero algo que tenemos que aprender de esto.
They were fearful.
Tenían temor.
Are you fearful?
¿Tienes tu temor?
Are you fearful that this isn't the right thing to do?
¿Tienes tu temor que este no es lo correcto de hacer?
Are you fearful that the church people are right?
¿Tienes temor de que la gente de la iglesia está correcta?
Shalom, this is Messianic Rabbi Andrew Dinnerman. I would personally like to thank you for tuning in to the Remnant's Call each and every week. You can listen to the full message on our website, bethgoyim.org. If you have drawn closer to the King of Kings, learned more about Him today, we are blessed. If you are blessed by these messages, please consider a donation to our ministry. You can go to our website, bethgoyim.org. That's BETHGOYIM.org. And click on the donate button. You do not have to have a PayPal account to donate. All you need is a debit card. Once again, thank you very much for listening to The Remnant's Call.
Those things are for the Jewish people.
Esas cosas son para gente judía.
Let me give you a hint.
Déjame darte una pista.
Messiah's Jewish.
El Mesías es judío.
And so were all the disciples.
Y también fueron los discípulos.
He never was a Christian.
Él nunca fue un cristiano.
Christianity didn't start till 300 years later.
La cristianidad no comenzó hasta sino 300 años después.
Actually, it was a derogatory term.
Era un término derogatorio este.
When they called them, oh, those were the Christians.
Cuando decían, esos son los
cristianos. They're the Christians.
Son los cristianos.
What does Christian mean?
¿Qué significa cristiano?
Those are the little Christs.
Son los pequeños Cristos.
Those are the little Jesuses.
Los pequeños Jesuses.
Well, they didn't call them Jesus.
No lo llamaron Jesús.
Those are the little Messiahs.
Son los pequeños Mesías.
It's almost like the N word.
Como la palabra N.
You know, that for that people use for the black people.
Que la gente utiliza para referirse a la gente de color.
But here, Israel was learning to change.
Pero aquí Israel está aprendiendo a cambiar.
This time of year.
Este tiempo del año.
Are you learning to change?
¿Estás tú aprendiendo a cambiar?
We just ended, Elmira, the spring holy days.
Hemos terminado los días santos de primavera.
Now it's a time of year that we begin to walk with God.
Ahora es el tiempo en el año que comenzamos a caminar con Dios.
Now put yourself in their position.
Ahora pónganse ustedes en esa posición.
You got Pharaoh over here.
Tienes al faraón aquí.
And you got an ocean over here.
Y tienes un océano aquí.
What would you do?
¿Qué harías tú?
Oh, madre mía, no! What would you do?
¿Qué harías tú?
We're gonna die, we're gonna die!
Dijeras, vamos a morir, vamos a morir.
Do you trust God?
¿Confías en Dios?
Now that you're walking with God.
Ahora que estás caminando con Dios.
And people are saying, well, those are Jewish things.
Y la gente dice, esas son cosas judías.
No, they're not Jewish things, they're Jesus's things.
No son cosas judías, son cosas de Jesús.
I use the name nice for once.
Utilizo el nombre.
They're not Jewish, they're Jesus.
No son judíos, sino son de
Jesús. Yeshua did them, you do them.
Yeshua lo hizo, tú debes hacerlo.
But that's what this time of year is all about.
Pero eso es lo que se trata este tiempo del año.
Learning to trust God.
Aprender a confiar en el Señor.
Look at verse 13.
Veamos al verso 13.
Moshe answered the people, stop being so fearful. Remain steady. And you will see how Jehovah is going to save you. He will do it today. He will do it today. Today you have seen the Egyptians, but you will never see them again. Amen? Amen. This is what a leader does.
Esto es lo que el líder hace.
He encourages them.
Él les da ánimo.
I encourage each and every one of you here.
Yo doy ánimo a cada uno de ustedes aquí.
Let's think about Martin for a moment.
Pensemos acerca de Martin.
Let's think about our brother Martin for a moment.
Pensemos de nuestro hermano Martin por un momento.
What if he were to die today?
¿Qué pasa si vas a morir hoy?
I'd be a little sad.
Estaré triste.
But I'd be really happy.
Pero también estaré feliz.
Because Martin's a Jew.
Porque Martin es un judío.
And Martin experienced Passover for the very first time. time.
Amen. Y Martín experimentó la Pascua por la primera vez. As a Jew, como judío.
As a place that welcomed him.
Como un lugar donde le dieron la bienvenida.
I know I'm going to see him at the table upstairs.
Yo sé que lo voy a ver en la mesa arriba.
I encourage each one of you to do the same.
Yo te animo a cada uno de ustedes a que hagan lo mismo.
Don't be fearful of death.
No tengan temor de la muerte.
Death is just a doorway.
La muerte es solo una puerta.
To Daddy's table.
Para la mesa del padre.
To go sitting there with Messiah and say, I got one bijones preguntas.
Para que te sientes junto a Yeshua y le digas, tengo muchísimas
preguntas. I got a billion questions, Lord.
Tengo muchas billones de preguntas para ti, Señor.
Don't be fearful.
No tengas temor.
If Yeshua did it,
si Yeshua lo hizo,
you do it.
Tú lo haces.
Because he'll never get mad at you for doing exactly what he did.
Porque no se enojará contigo si haces exactamente lo que él hizo.
So put yourself back with the Israelites.
Entonces pónganse ustedes como los israelitas.
Pharaoh's coming at you.
El faraón viene a ti.
Your leader says, remain steady.
Tu líder te dice, mantente en calma.
God's going to save us.
Dios nos salvará.
Remain steady.
Manténganse en calma.
Because we're walking with God.
Porque estamos caminando con Dios.
He's leading us.
Él nos está llevando.
He will save us.
Y él nos salvará.
You can trust in God's word.
Puedes confiar en la palabra de Dios.
Sometimes you got to trust with your hearts.
Hay veces que tienes que confiar con tu corazón.
And not with what your eyes see.
Y no con lo que tus ojos miran.
Satan is a really good illusionist.
Satanás es un verdadero ilusionista.
He makes things look really bad, right?
Él hace que las cosas se vean
but
muy
then
mal.
A blessing comes to your doorstep.
Pero la bendición viene a tu puerta.
God's looking for your hearts.
Dios está buscando tu corazón.
Trust with your hearts.
Confía con tu corazón.
Trust with your spirit.
Confía con tu espíritu.
But most of us trust with our eyes.
Pero la mayoría de nosotros confía con nuestros
many
ojos.
Of us trust with our eyes, right?
La mayoría de nosotros confía con
we
nuestros
trust
ojos.
With what our eyes see.
Confiamos en lo que nuestros ojos pueden ver.
God was leading us.
Dios nos estaba guiando.
And Moshe says, trust.
Y Moisés les dijo, confíen.
God's going to save us.
Dios nos salvará.
Now, if we put ourselves in their place,
si nos ponemos en el lugar de ellos,
if you put yourself in their place, Carmen,
si te pones en lugar de ellos,
would you have been like a Puerto Rican lady?
¿Será que vas a ser la mujer?
Ah, la. No, no, we're going to die.
No, vamos a morir.
Are you going to be like those people?
¿Vas a ser como esa gente?
Oh, those little Jewish people? God, we're going to die, Moses!
Esa gente judía que dice, no quiero morir, Moisés.
I wanted to go to Florida!
Quiero irme a Florida.
You know, but you got to learn how to trust. Walk in a new way of life.
Tienes que aprender a confiar y caminar en una nueva manera de vida.
Follow this narrow path.
Seguir su camino angosto.
This was the first narrow path.
Este era el primer camino angosto.
See, when Yeshua said, go through the narrow gates.
Cuando Yeshua dice, ve por la puerta angosta.
Who's he talking to?
¿A quién está hablando?
He's talking to a bunch of Jews.
Está hablando con muchos judíos.
What would I think is a narrow gate?
¿Qué pensaré que es una puerta angosta?
I'm leaving Egypt.
Estoy dejando Egipto.
The road, that path through the Red Sea was not this monster-sized path.
Ese camino por medio del mar de los juncos no era de un tamaño gigantesco.
It wasn't an 8-lane highway.
No era una línea de una autopista de 8 líneas.
It was a narrow path that we had to follow God on.
Era un camino angosto donde teníamos que seguir a Dios.
Look at verse 16.
Verso 16.
Lift your staff, reach out with your hand over the sea and divide it in two. The people of Israel will advance into the sea on dry ground. Amen.
Amen.
God?
Dios.
God?
Dios.
How do we advance into the sea on dry ground?
¿Cómo es que caminamos en el mar en tierra seca?
I don't think tunnels were made yet.
Yo no creo que los túneles estaban hechos aún.
There are really no Palestinians, but they're really good at making tunnels.
No hay palestinos que son buenos en hacer túneles.
What do you mean?
¿Qué quieres decir con eso?
Isn't dry land called land?
¿No es esa tierra seca llamada tierra?
Isn't the ocean called the sea?
¿No es el océano llamado el mar?
Doesn't a river have water in it?
¿No tiene un río agua en él?
Because if it doesn't have water in it, somebody's going to put a house on it, right?
Porque si no tiene agua, alguien va a poner una casa.
You know, you don't build a house underneath the water, right?
¿No construyes tu casa en el agua?
Or is this verse really more profound?
¿O es esto algo mucho más profundo?
See, what this verse is all about
de lo que se trata este verso
is the Jew and the Gentile,
es el judío y el gentil,
all of Israel,
todo Israel,
and the mixed multitude,
y la multitud mixta,
God was going to put them through the mikvah at the same time.
Dios los iba a hacer pasar por el mikvah a la misma vez.
Let me say that again.
Déjame decir otra vez.
God was going to put Jew and Gentile,
Dios iba a poner al judío y al gentil,
through the mikvah at the same time.
A pasarlos por el mikvah a la misma vez.
Jew and Gentile,
judío y gentil,
were going to leave death of slavery behind,
iban a dejar la muerte de la esclavitud atrás,
to walk in this new life,
para caminar en esta nueva vida,
away from the house of bondage,
lejos de la casa de la esclavitud.
Hold your place there in Exodus.
Mantén tu lugar aquí en Éxodo.
Now go back to Romans where I had you hold your place before.
Y vamos de vuelta a Romanos donde te dije que mantengas la página.
Romans 6 now.
Romanos 6 ahora.
Welcome to Beth Goyim. You've only
Bienvenido
been here
Beth
4
Goyim.
Years. Romans 6.
Romanos 6.
Verse 4.
Verso 4.
Through immersion into his death, we were buried with him, so that just as through the glory of the Father, the Messiah was raised from the dead, likewise, we too might live a new life. Amen?
Amen.
Immersion into death of the old life.
La inmersión de la muerte, lejos de la muerte de la vida antigua.
Okay, so now we're going into the sea.
Vamos ahora a entrar al mar.
We're leaving that old life of death behind us.
Estamos dejando esa vida antigua de muerte atrás.
Immersion speaks of leaving the old life behind.
La inmersión habla de dejar la vida vieja atrás.
And learning to trust in a new life, Noé.
Y aprender a confiar en una nueva vida.
Learning to trust God.
Aprender a confiar en el, en
learning
Dios.
To be here on the holy days.
Aprender a estar aquí en los días santos.
Learning to trust God with everything.
Aprender a confiar en Dios en todo.
Learning to be here when you're supposed to be here.
Aprender a estar aquí cuando se supone que debe estar aquí.
Leaving the old life behind, Darwin.
Dejar la vida antigua atrás.
Means what we do is we stop sinning.
Significa que hacemos lo que hacemos es dejar de pecar.
See, when you leave the old life behind, Giselle.
Cuando dejamos la vida atrás,
when you leave the old life behind,
cuando dejamos la vida antigua atrás,
you don't go sin more so God could give you more grace.
Tú no vas a ir a pecar más para que Dios te dé más gracia.
Oh man, let's go party really hard now,
vamos
Veronica.
Vamos a festejar ahora.
Let's go drink really heavily.
Vamos a beber mucho.
Mucha cerveza.
A lot of beer.
Oh, let's have some marijuana too.
Fumemos también marihuana.
And to top it off, let's have a little cocaine.
Y para terminar con cocaína.
Because God's going to show us more grace.
Porque el Señor nos va a mostrar más gracia.
Now what Paul is talking about here.
Lo que Pablo está hablando aquí.
He wants you to be immersed.
Él quiere que seas sumergido.
Into walking with God.
En caminar con Dios.
Leaving the house of bondage behind.
Dejar la casa de la esclavitud atrás.
That's what this time of year is all about.
De eso se trata este tiempo del año.
We now crossed over the Red Sea.
Ya hemos cruzado el Mar Rojo.
See, what does the word Hebrew mean?
¿Qué significa la palabra hebreo?
What does the word Hebrew mean?
¿Qué significa la palabra hebreo?
One who crosses over.
Uno que cruza.
Jew and Gentile,
judío y gentil,
became one family of Hebrews.
Se hicieron una familia de hebreos.
When we went through the Reed Sea.
Cuando pasamos por el mar de los juncos.
Let me say that again.
Déjame decir otra vez.
Jew and Gentile,
el judío y el gentil,
became one family.
Se hicieron una familia.
Through the immersion.
Por medio de la inmersión.
When we crossed over to the other side of the Reed Sea.
Cuando cruzamos al otro lado del mar de los juncos.
Hold your place in Romans.
Mantengan su lugar en Romanos.
Go back to Exodus 14.
Y vamos de vuelta a Éxodo 14.
Exodus 14.
Éxodo 14.
Verse 22 and 23 now.
Versos 22 y 23.
Exodus 14.
Éxodo 14.
Verse 22 and 23.
Versos 22 al 23.
Then the people of Israel went into the sea on dry ground with the water walled up for them on the right and on the left. The Egyptians continued their pursuit, going after them into the sea. All Pharaoh's horses, chariots, and cavalry. Amen? See, this full immersion,
esta inmersión completa,
will lead to a new life.
Te va a guiar a una nueva vida.
With Israel and a mixed multitude fully immersed.
Con Israel y una multitud mixta sumergida.
Now how were they immersed?
¿Cómo es que fueron sumergidos?
Now they sent a submarine down. Into the Reed Sea.
Oh, I'm sorry?
They sent a submarine down into the Reed Sea.
Mandaron un submarino al Mar Rojo.
And they found the chariots.
Y encontraron las carrocerías.
In 3,000 feet of water.
A 3,000 pies de profundidad del Mar Rojo.
So picture yourself.
Imagínate.
Picture yourself, everybody.
Imagínate.
You've left Egypt.
Dejaste Egipto.
You've been a slave.
Has sido esclavo.
In front of you.
Y enfrente tuyo.
Is water.
Es agua.
Lots of water.
Mucha agua.
You can't even see.
Ni siquiera puedes mirar.
You can't even see the other side.
Ni siquiera puedes mirar el otro lado.
Behind you.
Y detrás tuyo.
Is Pharaoh.
Está el faraón.
And now.
Y ahora.
The water parts in front of you.
El agua se abre enfrente tuyo.
And walking through the water.
Y caminar a través del agua.
Is 3,000 feet of water on your right.
Tú ves que hay 3,000 pies de agua en tu lado derecho.
3,000 feet of water on your left.
Y 3,000 pies de agua en la izquierda.
Oh, I hope it doesn't fall.
Espero que no se caiga.
What would you do?
¿Qué harías tú?
I'm running.
Yo corro.
I trust God just so much.
Yo confío en Dios solo.
But picture this.
Pero imagínate esto.
You've been a slave.
Has sido esclavo.
You've been a slave.
Has sido un esclavo.
You know, that's all you've known.
Es todo lo que sabías.
Now God has let you free.
Dios ahora te está dejando libre.
And the water parts before you.
Y el agua se abre delante tuyo.
And Moses says, go on dry grounds.
Y Moisés dice, vayan a tierra seca.
What would you say?
¿Y qué le dirías tú?
You first.
Tuve primero. Tuve primero.
Be a leader, I'll do it. I'm
going to
trust
líder,
God.
Voy a decir, okay, lo haré.
So you're walking.
Voy a confiar en Dios.
Now, you can't see, you're walking down.
Ahora tú estás bajando, caminando para abajo.
Remember, it's 3,000 feet down.
Recuerda que son 3,000 pies de profundidad.
But you got to get to the other side.
Pero tienes que llegar al otro lado.
To have this new life, David.
Para tener esta nueva vida.
And you're walking with these Gentiles.
Y estás caminando con estos gentiles.
And all, as a family together, you're going to do this together.
Y como una familia junta van a hacer esto.
You're going to be
juntos.
Fully immersed.
Van a ser sumergidos completamente.
Into God's waters.
En las aguas de Dios.
Because you're not going to be able to see the other side.
Porque no vas a poder mirar el otro lado.
It isn't a cliff like, you know, in Ireland.
No es una quebrada como en Irlanda.
It's a steady decline.
Es una gradualmente va bajando.
So you're seeing water all around you.
Ves agua alrededor tuyo.
Where's this guy Moses leading us?
¿A dónde nos está llevando este Moisés?
You got to learn to walk in the new life.
Tienes que aprender a caminar en la nueva vida.
You got to learn to walk with the anointed leaders.
Tienes que aprender a caminar con los líderes ungidos.
You got to go through this full immersion in your life.
Tienes que pasar por esta inmersión completa en tu vida.
Learn how to trust God and His Word.
Aprende a confiar en Dios y en su palabra.
Learning how to trust.
Aprender cómo confiar.
While the old life wants to draw you back.
Mientras la vida antigua te quiere traer de vuelta.
What did they say?
¿Qué dijeron ellos?
Why did you just leave us in Egypt?
¿Por qué no nos dejaste en Egipto?
You were the ones that were crying out to God.
Ustedes son los que estaban clamando al Señor.
So you wanted the truth, David.
Tú quieres la verdad.
You were reading the Bible, David.
Tú estás leyendo
just
la
like
Biblia.
That David was
así como ese David estaba leyendo
you
la
both
Biblia.
Did the same thing.
Ustedes hicieron lo mismo.
Why aren't we doing this?
¿Por qué estamos haciendo esto?
Why aren't we doing the Sabbath?
¿Por qué estamos guardando el sábado?
Why aren't we doing these holy days?
¿Por qué estamos guardando estos días
and
santos?
Your pastor and his pastor said the same stupid thing.
Y tu pastor y su pastor dijo la misma estupidez.
Well, those are for the Jews.
Esos son para los judíos.
Those are done away with.
Esos ya se acabaron.
We're under a new thing.
Estamos bajo algo
those
nuevo.
Old things are gone, right?
Esas cosas antiguas
that's what
se
you heard, fueron. Right? Those old things are gone.
Esas cosas, ya se acabaron.
Well, then so is salvation.
Pero también, entonces, la salvación.
Salvation was 2,000 years ago.
Porque la salvación fue 2,000 años atrás.
If those old things are gone,
si esas dos, esas cosas antiguas se
then
terminaron,
so is salvation.
Entonces, también la salvación.
If God chose a new group of people,
si Dios escogió un nuevo grupo de personas,
then he's a God I don't want to follow.
Entonces, él es un Dios que yo no quiero seguir.
My God keeps his promises.
Mi Dios guarda sus promesas.
My God never forgets.
Mi Dios nunca se olvida.
But the old life tries to draw you back.
Pero la vida antigua te está tratando de llamar de vuelta.
You got the old church people calling you.
Tienes la iglesia antigua que te llama.
David, you're still doing those Jewish things?
Aún sigues haciendo esas cosas antiguas.
Yes, look at my nose. I must be Jewish.
Mira mi nariz, soy judío.
Yes, I'm doing those things.
Estoy haciendo esas cosas.
And you should be too.
Y deberías hacerlas tú también.
Because what did Messiah say at the last Passover meal?
Porque qué dijo el Mesías en la última cena de Pascua.
Do this in remembrance of me.
Haz esto en memoria mía.
How many Gentiles were at that Passover meal?
¿Cuántos gentiles estaban en esa cena de Pascua?
Zero.
Cero.
None.
No, ninguno.
None.
Ninguno.
So here, you're walking through that 3,000 feet of water.
Estás caminando a 3,000 pies de agua.
And you're watching people go ahead of you.
Y estás mirando a la gente que va
adelante. You can go first.
Pues tú primero.
Go ahead, David. David,
tú.
Go ahead.
Ve tú.
Oh, Frank, you're a Gentile. Go ahead.
Por favor, sigue. Tú eres un gentil.
Isabel, you're Greek. Go ahead.
Tú eres griega.
Oh, go ahead, go ahead. The Dominicans, go. All of you, go.
Dominicans, váyanse todos ustedes.
Haitians, go ahead. Puerto Ricans, lead the way.
Puerto Ricanos, vayan adelante.
You know? Because why are you doing that?
¿Por qué haces eso?
Because you got that old life.
Porque tienes esa vida antigua.
We should go do Christmas again.
Deberíamos celebrar Navidad otra vez.
Jesus rose from the grave on Sunday.
Jesús resucitó el domingo.
What should I do?
¿Qué debo hacer?
What should I do?
¿Qué debo hacer?
This time of year, it's about all about walking with God.
Este tiempo del año se trata de caminar con Dios.
It's all about a choice you got to make.
Se trata de la elección que debes hacer.
It's all about a choice you got to make.
Se trata de la elección que debes hacer.
Do you look at the reed sea and you don't go through?
Miras al mar de los juncos y no pasas por él.
Jew and Gentile had to leave the old life behind.
El judío y el gentil tenía que dejar la vida antigua atrás.
To walk with God.
Para caminar con Dios.
Moses, do you want to walk with Moses?
Moisés, ¿quieres caminar con Moisés?
Do you want to walk with God?
¿Quieres caminar con Dios?
Walking with Messiah.
Caminar con el Mesías
means leaving the old life
significa dejar la vida antigua
behind
atrás
and starting a new life.
Y comenzar una nueva vida.
You got to leave the drinking behind.
Debes dejar la bebida atrás.
Rav Ed had to leave the drinking behind.
Rav Noé tuvo que dejar la bebida atrás.
He at least played the guitar.
Él tocaba la guitarra.
He was like Carlos Santana.
Como Carlos Santana.
He made Carlos look like he would nothing, man.
Hacía ver a Carlos como nada.
Give me another drink.
Okay.
He had to leave that behind.
Tuvo que dejar eso atrás.
And when he left that behind,
y cuando dejó eso atrás,
the Lord gave them Leveruni.
El Señor les dio Lev.
When he left that life behind,
cuando él dejó esa vida atrás,
and he started to walk with God,
y comenzó a caminar con Dios,
he gave them a new heart.
Él les dio un nuevo corazón.
So here, we're looking at the scripture.
Estamos mirando la escritura.
Jew and Gentile went through the immersion together.
El judío y el gentil pasaron inmersión juntos.
Because that's what God wants.
Porque eso es lo que Dios quiere.
One law for the Jew and the Gentile.
Una ley para el judío y el gentil.
And we had to follow the angel into the water.
Y debimos seguir al ángel al agua.
Who's that angel that led us in the
¿Quién
desert?
¿Quién es ese ángel que nos guió en el desierto? Era Yeshua.
Yeshua is the angel.
Yeshua es el ángel.
Because the Father said what?
Porque el Padre dijo qué?
Follow my angel that has my name inside of him.
Sigue mi ángel que tiene su nombre dentro de él.
We had to follow Yeshua.
Tenemos que seguir a Yeshua.
So Yeshua said.
Yeshua dijo.
Sígueme.
Sígame.
Follow me.
Sígueme.
Yeah, we can walk through 3,000 feet of water.
Sí, podemos caminar a través de
3,000
pies de agua.
Yeah, that's what I'm talking about. Yeah, Shin Sin. That's what I'm talking about.
Eso estoy hablando.
We can walk through the water if we trust.
Si caminarías en el agua si confías.
If we follow Yeshua's example, we can get to the other side.
Si seguimos el ejemplo de Yeshua, podemos llegar al otro lado.
But if you don't trust.
Pero si no confías.
But if you don't trust.
Pero si no confías.
You will not be a Hebrew and you will not get to the other side.
Tú no serás un hebreo y no vas a poder llegar al otro lado.
Hold your place in Exodus.
Mantenga su lugar en Éxodo.
Go back to Romans 6, please.
Y vamos de vuelta a Romanos 6.
Anybody learning anything so far?
¿Alguien está aprendiendo algo?
Romans 6, please, verse 4 again.
Romanos 6, verso 4.
Romans 6, verse 4.
Romanos 6, verso 4.
talking about water so much, I had to take a drink.
Hablando del agua.
Through immersion into his death, we were buried with him, so that just as through the glory of the Father, the Messiah was raised from the dead, likewise we too might live a new life. Amen?
Amen.
Glory of the Father.
La gloria del Padre.
In that passage of Exodus,
en ese pasaje de Éxodo,
the Father said twice,
el Padre dijo dos veces,
I will win glory for myself, when?
Yo ganaré gloria para mí, ¿cuándo?
When I destroy the Egyptians.
Cuando destruya a los egipcios.
So this is what Paul is talking about.
De eso es lo que Pablo está hablando.
I bet you've never seen Romans 6 like this before.
Creo que no viste Romanos de esa manera
we,
antes.
You know, we're going to be immersed into Yeshua's death.
Tenemos que ser sumergidos en la muerte de Yeshua.
We got to start worshiping on Sunday.
Debemos adorar el domingo.
No, that's not what he's talking about.
De eso no está hablando él.
This is a Jewish book.
Este es un libro judío.
And the key word here, glory of the Father.
Y la clave aquí es la gloria del Padre.
Father said twice.
El Padre dijo dos veces.
In Exodus there.
En Éxodo.
I'm going to win glory for myself.
Voy a ganar gloria para mí mismo.
When I immerse them into death,
cuando lo sumerjan a muerte,
you're going to get a new life.
Tú vas a obtener una nueva vida.
And I will win glory for myself, says the Father.
Yo ganaré gloria para mí, dice el Padre.
How many people want the Father to have some glory?
¿Cuántos quieren que el Padre tenga
gloria? Amen. I want you to have all the glory.
Yo quiero que tengas toda la gloria.
I want to see you magnified today.
Quiero verte magnificado hoy.
Go back to Exodus. Hold your place in Romans.
Mantengan su lugar en Romanos y vamos a Éxodo.
Go back to Exodus 14.
Vámonos a Éxodo 14.
Exodus 14.
Éxodo 14.
Verse 22 and 23 now.
Versos 22 y 23.
Shemot 14.
Éxodo 14.
Verse 22 and 23.
Versos 22 y 23.
Then the people of Israel went into the sea on dry ground with the water walled up for them on their right and on their left. The Egyptians continued their pursuit, going after them into the sea. All Pharaoh's horses, chariots, and cavalry. Amen? The evil wants to pursue you.
El mal quiere perseguirte.
You've all been called by your old churches, right?
Todos han sido llamados por sus iglesias
Everybody's
antiguas.
Been called by their old churches.
A todos los llamaron las iglesias well, antiguas.
You know, did old friends call you, Kathy?
Te llamaron tus amigos.
We, Kathy, we didn't see you.
No te vimos ahora, Kathy.
Kathy, how come you're not coming back?
¿Dónde has been? ¿De cuándo regresas?
They all call you. They want to pursue you.
Te llamarán. Quieren alcanzarte.
God didn't say the Egyptians couldn't follow us.
Dios le dijo. I'm sorry.
God didn't say the Egyptians couldn't follow us.
Dios no dijo que los egipcios no nos podían seguir.
Leave your military stuff behind.
Deja tu milicia atrás.
And walk with the King of Israel.
Y camina con el Rey de Israel.
People are trying to always call you back.
La gente siempre trata de llamarte de vuelta.
Now this was written before you spoke yesterday.
Esto fue antes de haber hablado.
Because God's speaking.
Porque Dios está hablando.
The choice is yours.
La elección es tuya.
I'm going to walk through the water.
Yo voy a caminar
I'm going to walk through the water.
Yo voy a caminar por el agua.
Because you know what?
Porque sabes qué?
God says he'll protect us here.
Dios dice que nos protegerá.
God says you're going to see them no more.
Dios dice que ya no los verás.
People are going to try to draw you back.
La gente va a tratar de traerte de vuelta.
But if you start walking with God,
pero si comienzas a caminar con Dios,
those people will walk away.
Esa gente se alejará.
Because once you start telling them the truth,
porque una vez que les comienzas a hablar de la verdad,
they don't want to hear the truth.
Ellos no quieren escuchar la verdad.
God says, I will protect you from your enemies.
Dios dice, yo te protegeré de tus enemigos.
If you walk in my boundaries, Frankie.
Si tú caminas en mis límites.
If you walk, what are the boundaries?
¿Cuáles son los límites?
Tiffany, what are the boundaries that we have to walk in? In accordance with this word right here.
De acuerdo con esta palabra aquí, ¿cuáles son los límites?
What are the boundaries?
¿Cuáles son los límites?
What are the boundaries that we need? Danny, you're next.
¿Cuáles son los límites que
what are the boundaries? We're going to talk, write the word boundaries and write it correctly.
Son las palabras,
boundaries.
Palabra
boundaries. Okay? What are the boundaries?
¿Cuáles son los límites?
What are the boundaries that we need to walk with God about?
¿Cuáles son los límites que necesitamos caminar con
Dios? What are the boundaries?
¿Cuáles son los límites?
The water on the right
el agua en la derecha.
And the water on the left.
Y el agua en la izquierda.
God says you walk in those boundaries,
Dios dice, caminas en esos,
you're going to get to life on the other side.
Tú vas a obtener vida en el otro lado.
What happens if you go, hey, that...
¿Qué pasa, tú vas así?
You know, the water was walled up.
El agua estaba como paredes.
What happens if you walk into the wall?
¿Qué pasa si caminabas a la pared?
Habalam, habalak.
Habalam, habalak. Oh, balam y balak.
Okay. What happened when he's trying to go through that narrow road and the angel was blocking him?
¿Qué pasa cuando estaba tratando de pasar por ese camino angosto y el ángel lo bloqueó?
You get hurt.
Te lastimas.
If you go outside those boundaries, you get hurt.
Si tú sales de esos límites, serás mal herido.
But if you're walking with God,
pero si estás caminando con Dios,
nobody can steal you away from God.
Nadie te robará de Dios.
The wall speaks of separation.
La pared habla de separación.
Between holy and unholy.
Entre santo y lo que no es santo.
If you go outside the walls of God, you are unholy.
Si tú sales de las paredes de Dios, tú ya no serás santo.
If you are doing Sunday worship, you are unholy.
Si estás haciendo adoración del domingo, tú no eres santo.
For the fourth commandment is still the fourth commandment.
Porque el cuarto mandamiento es aún el cuarto mandamiento.
If salvation is still salvation,
si la salvación es aún salvación,
then so is the fourth commandment.
Entonces también es el cuarto mandamiento.
But people will try to destroy your new life.
Pero la gente tratará de destruir tu nueva vida.
But if you walk with God,
pero si caminas con Dios,
look what happens to your enemies.
Mira lo que pasa con tus enemigos.
Look at verse 27 and 28.
Vamos al verso 27 y 28.
Moisés reached out his hand over the sea, and by dawn the sea had returned to its former depth. The Egyptians tried to flee, but Jehovah swept them into the sea. The water came back and covered all the chariots, the cavalry, and a cavalry of Pharaoh's army who had followed them into the sea. Not even one of them was left. Amen? So the Egyptians were immersed.
Los egipcios fueron sumergidos.
But they were immersed into death.
Pero fueron sumergidos a la muerte.
We were immersed into life because we were walking with God.
Nosotros fuimos sumergidos a la vida porque caminamos con Dios.
If you walk in obedience,
si estás caminando en obediencia,
Jew and Gentile,
el judío y el gentil,
walked through in obedience.
Caminaron en obediencia.
We walked together. Mr.
Caminamos
Gabriel, stand
juntos.
Up. Jew and Gentile walk together in obedience.
Amen?
That's what it's about.
De eso se trata.
Walking together.
Caminar juntos.
God loves him as much as he loves me.
Dios le ama a él tanto como me ama a mí.
Amen. Walk together.
Caminar juntos.
We walk together, we could be an army for God.
Caminamos juntos, podemos ser un ejército para Dios.
But the key word is together.
Pero la clave aquí es juntos.
Together.
Juntos.
Following God.
Siguiendo a Dios.
He said it, we do it.
Él dijo, lo hacemos.
Look at verse 29. But the people of Israel walked on dry ground in the sea with the water walled up for them on the right and on the left. Amen? See, when you walk with God,
cuando caminamos con Dios,
God protects you.
Dios te protege.
When you listen to God,
cuando escuchas a Dios,
God protects you.
Dios te protege.
You can have sin all around you.
Vas a tener pecado alrededor tuyo.
But remember, there was a man called Noach.
Pero recuerda que había un hombre que se llamaba Noé.
There was a man called Noach.
Había un hombre que se llamaba
and
Noé.
There was sin all around him, right?
Y había pecado alrededor
but
de
then
él.
God brought the flood waters, right?
Pero el Señor trajo las aguas de la inundación.
And God saved those that were righteous with Noah.
Y Dios salvó aquellos que eran justos con Noé.
He went into the tavila, into the ark.
Él entró en el tavila o en el arca.
But those that hated God drowned.
Pero aquellos que odiaban a Dios se ahogaron.
The Egyptians hated God.
Los egipcios odiaban a Dios.
They hated the people of God.
Odiaban a la gente
but
de Dios.
But we got to walk on dry ground.
Pero nosotros tenemos que caminar en tierra seca.
With the water on the right and on the left.
Con el agua en la derecha
and
y en la
when
izquierda.
You came up on the other side.
Y cuando llegabas al otro lado.
You are now walking in the new life.
Tú ya entrabas a la nueva vida.
Now we're going to go on to theme number two.
Ahora vamos al tema tres.
Did you learn something from theme number one?
¿Aprendiste algo del tema uno?
We're going to now build on that theme.
Ahora comenzaremos a construir en ese tema.
As we spoke about Hag Matzah.
Como hablábamos de Hag Matzah.
Number seven, we spoke about it.
Número siete, hablamos eso.
The holy days mark our redemption.
Los días santos hablan de nuestra redención.
The holy days is to remind us
los días santos es para recordarnos
who we are.
Quiénes somos.
and who we are supposed to be.
¿Y quiénes se supone que debemos ser?
Every time you do the holy days,
cada vez que celebras los días santos,
you're supposed to change your life.
Se supone que debes cambiar tu vida.
You're supposed to get closer with the Lord and our King.
Debes acercarte con el Señor nuestro Rey.
Especially during the spring holy days.
Especialmente durante los días santos de primavera.
During the feast of Pesach, Passover.
Durante la fiesta de Pascua.
That we do each year with the Seder.
Que hacemos cada año con el Seder.
You're supposed to teach the children.
Tú debes enseñar a los niños.
And so the children ask, why are we doing this Seder?
Así si los niños preguntan por qué estamos celebrando el Seder.
But when you know that the Seder is about leaving slavery.
Pero cuando sabemos que el Seder se trata de dejar la esclavitud.
But if you're not doing it, the Seder properly.
Pero si no celebras el Seder apropiadamente.
You know, you tell you, oh, we're supposed to do this because we're Jewish.
Le dices a tu hijo, debemos hacer esto porque somos judíos.
Your child might be respectful.
Tu hijo será respetuoso.
But in their mind, they're thinking you're stupid.
Pero en su mente, ellos piensan que eres estúpido.
If you can't explain the holy days to your children,
si no puedes explicar los días santos a tus hijos,
then your child will walk away from God.
Entonces, tu hijo se alejará de Dios.
If you're a Sunday Christian,
si eres un cristiano del domingo,
and you tell your child to read the Bible,
y le dices a tu hijo que lea la Biblia,
and your kid actually reads the Bible,
y tu hijo lee la Biblia,
this is what happened to Rav Will and his wife Reina.
Eso le pasó a Rabino Will y a su esposa Reina.
They were pastors or ministers at a church.
Eran ministros de una iglesia.
One of the kids came to them and said,
y uno de los niños vino y le dijeron,
in Sunday school,
en escuela dominical,
why don't we keep the Sabbath?
¿Por qué no guardamos el sábado?
And he tried to explain it to her.
Y le trató de explicar a ella.
The more he tried to explain it to her,
y lo más que él trató de explicarle a ella,
the kid was like, uh-uh.
El niño de la niña decía,
it says we're supposed to keep the seventh day.
Dice aquí que debemos guardar el séptimo día.
So this is what the day after Hag Matzah is all about.
De eso se trata el día después de Hag Matzah.
Now we're going to walk in that new life.
Ahora vamos a caminar en esa nueva vida.
Now we're going to start walking with God.
Ahora vamos a comenzar a caminar con Dios.
You can walk on your own path.
Puedes caminar en tu propio
lugar. But when you walk away from God,
pero cuando te alejas de Dios,
there's scorpions and snakes over there.
Hay escorpiones y culebras allí.
When you walk away from God on this side,
cuando caminas lejos de Dios de esta manera,
there's a 3,000 foot cliff.
Hay una quebrada de 3,000 pies de profundidad.
Or you walk a narrow path.
O caminas el camino angosto.
I used to ask my mother, why are we doing Passover?
Yo solía preguntar a mi madre por qué se.
My mother used to say.
Mi madre solía decir.
Because we're Jews, that's why.
Porque somos judíos, por eso.
And it's like, I didn't want to do it.
Yo decía, no lo quiero hacer.
The key is to do what Jehovah wants you to do.
La clave es hacer lo que Jehová quiere que hagas.
The key is to do what He wants you to do.
Tienes que hacer lo que él quiere que hagas.
The spring holy days are a spiritual reminder.
Los días de primavera son un recordatorio.
That those of us who love Elohim.
De aquellos que aman a Elohim.
And you really want to bless Him.
Y realmente quieres bendecirlo.
You do what He wants you to do.
Tú haces lo que quiere, lo que él quiere que hagas.
The spring holy days.
Los días santos.
Are a memorial.
Son un recordatorio.
To say, I remember leaving bondage and I don't want to go back there.
Para decir, yo recuerdo la esclavitud y no quiero regresar allá.
Hag Matzah.
Hag Matzah.
We're saying we're willing to trust in the word and to bring us out of Egypt.
Estamos diciendo, estamos dispuestos a confiar en la palabra y a salir de Egipto.
In Yom HaBikurim, first fruits.
Y en los primeros frutos, Yom HaBikurim.
You're willing to give God your best offering.
Tú estabas dispuesto a darle a Dios tu mejor ofrenda.
Now with that in mind,
con eso en mente,
go back to Romans 6.
Vámonos a Romanos 6.
Romans 6.
Romanos 6.
Verse 1 through 4 now again.
Versos 1 al 4 otra vez.
So then are we to say, let's keep on sinning so that it can be more grace? Heaven forbid! How can we who have died to sin still live in it? Don't you know that those of us who have been immersed into the Messiah Yeshua have been immersed into His death? Through immersion into His death, we are buried with Him, so that just as through the glory of the Father, the Messiah was raised from the dead. Likewise, we too might live a new life. Amen? Amen. Let's look closer at verse 1 and 2.
Veamos de vuelta el verso 1 y 2.
So then we are to say, let's keep on sinning so that there can be more grace? Heaven forbid. How can we who have died to sin still live in it? Amen?
Amen.
The Gentile church says that we're living under grace.
Dice que estamos viviendo bajo la gracia.
And that we're no longer under the laws of God.
Y que ya no necesitamos las leyes de Dios.
Then I have a question then.
Tengo una pregunta entonces.
How do I know what sin is?
¿Cómo sé que es pecado?
What is Paul talking about here in verse 1?
¿De qué habla Pablo aquí en el verso 1?
If we don't have to study the laws of God,
si no tenemos que estudiar las leyes de Dios,
how do I know what sin is?
¿Cómo yo sé que es pecado?
How do I know that I'm sinning?
Como yo sé que estoy pecando.
So that I can't, I don't want any more grace.
Así ya no necesito gracia.
These two verses, what you're seeing here,
estos dos versos que están viendo aquí,
are directly related to the spring holy days.
Están relacionados directamente a los días santos de primavera.
If we've died to sin,
si morimos en al pecado,
and immersed into him,
y sumergidos a él,
Paul's talking about leaving Egypt.
Pablo está hablando acerca de dejar Egipto.
Leaving those pagan gods behind.
Dejando esos dioses paganos atrás.
Leaving that pagan way of living behind.
Dejando esa manera de vivir pagana
leave
atrás.
Leave the sin behind you. Leave Pharaoh behind you.
Dejando el pecado atrás. Dejas al faraón atrás.
And be a Hebrew and get to the other side.
Y que seas un hebreo y camines al otro lado.
That's what he's talking about in verse 1 and 2.
De eso está hablando en el verso 1 y 2.
How can we have died, those of us who have died to sin,
aquellos que hemos muerto al pecado,
how can you still live in your mind back in Egypt?
¿Cómo puedes vivir en tu mente todavía en Egipto?
You need to leave Egypt behind.
Necesitas dejar Egipto atrás.
If we've left the old pagan
si dejamos la manera pagana de antigua.
If we have left the ways of man,
si hemos dejado las maneras del
Rosa,
hombre,
how can we still live in it?
¿Cómo podemos seguir viviendo en él?
Rosa, how can we still live in it?
¿Cómo podemos seguir viviendo en él?
How do we know that Paul is talking about the spring holy days?
¿Cómo sabemos que Pablo está hablando de los días santos de primavera?
Hold your place there.
Mantén tu lugar allí.
Now go to Exodus 32.
Vamos a Éxodo 32.
Exodus 32.
Éxodo 32.
We're going to look at the key verse verse 4.
Vamos a ver el verso clave primero, verso 4.
Exodus 32.
Éxodo 32.
Then we'll come back to Romans.
Y regresaremos a Romanos.
Then we'll get to Ephesians.
Después de Efesios.
There's a lot of scripture we're going to get to in the second part.
Mucha escritura veremos en la segunda parte.
Exodus 32, verse 4.
Éxodo 32, verso 4.
He received what they gave him, melted it down, and made it into a shape of a calf. They said, Israel, here is your God who brought you up from the land of Egypt. Amen?
Amen.
Amen?
Amen.
What's so important about this?
¿Qué es importante acerca de esto?
Where did we see idols being made?
¿Dónde vemos que los ídolos fueron hechos?
In Egypt.
En Egipto.
See, the people of Israel left Egypt.
La gente de Israel dejó Egipto.
The mixed multitude left Egypt.
La multitud mixta dejó Egipto.
They had manna fall from heaven in Exodus 16.
Tuvieron el maná que cayó del cielo en Éxodo 16.
God spoke the Ten Commandments in Exodus 20.
Dios habló los diez mandamientos en Éxodo 20.
But here Moshe's up on the mountain.
Pero aquí Moisés está en la montaña.
Getting the handwritten Ten Commandments.
Recibiendo los diez mandamientos escritos.
And instead of walking with the Lord, trusting in Him,
y en lugar de caminar con el Señor y confiar en Él,
we go right back to the old way of life.
Regresamos de vuelta a la vida antigua de vivir.
Make us gods that we can see.
Haznos dioses que podemos ver.
Lisbeth, make us gods that we can see.
Haznos dioses que podamos ver.
You don't have to see God to know that there is God.
Tú no tienes que ver a Dios para saber que hay un
Understand
Dios.
You're standing on a ball.
Entiende que estás parado en
The earth is
pelota.
Round. The la earth
tierra,
is round.
La tierra es redonda.
And the water is not falling off.
Y el agua no se está cayendo.
Try putting a ball under your faucets.
Trata de poner una bola abajo de las llaves de
agua. And see how much water stays on the ball.
Veamos cuánta agua queda en la pelota.
Not a sponge ball.
No es una pelota de esponja.
Not SpongeBob.
No es una pelota esponja.
Put a baseball.
Una pelota de béisbol.
Under your faucets.
Bajo las llaves de agua.
Margarita, put a baseball under your faucet.
Pon una pelota de béisbol debajo de la
llave. And turn the water on.
Y préndele el agua.
See how much water stays on that baseball.
Fíjate cuánta agua queda en la pelota de béisbol.
God is all around us, everybody.
Dios está alrededor de nosotros.
Now let's read the rest of this.
Ahora leamos el resto de esto.
Let's read Exodus, Shemot 32.
Vamos a leer Éxodo 31.
Verse 1 through 25.
Del 1 al 25.
This part is called, they left Egypt, but Egypt didn't leave them.
Esta parte se titula, dejaron Egipto, pero Egipto no los dejó a ellos.
Exodus 32, verse 1 through 25.
Éxodo 32, versos 1 al 25.
When the people saw that Moshe was taking a long time to come down from the mountain, they gathered around Aaron and said to him, get busy and make us gods to go ahead of us. Because this, Moshe, the man that brought us up from the land of Egypt, we don't know what happened, what became of him. Aaron said to them, have your wives and sons and daughters strip off their gold earrings and bring them to me. The people stripped off their gold earrings and brought them to Aaron. He received what they gave him, melted it down, and made it into the shape of a calf. They said, Israel, here is your God who brought you up from the land of Egypt. On seeing this, Aaron built an altar in front of it and proclaimed, tomorrow is to be a feast for Jehovah. Early in the morning, they got up and offered burnt offerings and presented peace offerings. Afterwards, the people sat down to eat and drink. They got up to indulge in revelry. Jehovah said to Moshe, go down, hurry. Your people whom you brought up from the land of Egypt have become corrupt. So quickly they have turned aside from the way I ordered them to follow. They have cast a metal statue of a calf, worshipped it, sacrificed to it, and said, Israel, here is your God who brought you up from the land of Egypt. Jehovah continued speaking to Moshe, I have been watching these people and you can see how stiff-necked they are. Now leave me alone so that my anger can blaze up against them and I put an end to them. I will make a great nation out of you instead. Moshe pleaded with Jehovah, his Elohim. He said, Jehovah, why must your anger blaze against your own people, whom you brought up out of the land of Egypt with great power and a strong hand? Why let the Egyptians say it was with an evil intention that he led them out to slaughter them in the hills and wipe them off the face of the earth? Turn from your fierce anger. Relent. Don't bring such disaster on your people. Remember Abraham, Yitzhak, and Yisrael, your servants, to whom you swore by your very self. You promised them. I'll make your descendants as many as the stars in the sky. I will give all this land I have spoken about to your descendants. They will possess it forever. Jehovah then changed his mind about the disaster he had planned for the people. Moshe turned and went down from the mountain with the two tablets of the testimony in his hand. Tablets inscribed on both sides, front and the back. The tablets were the work of Elohim. The writing was the writing of Elohim engraved on the tablets. When Yehoshua heard the noise, people shouting, he said, it sounds like war in the camp. He answered, that is neither clamor of victory nor the wailings of defeat. What I hear is the sound of people singing. But the moment Moshe got near the camp, when he saw the calf and dancing, his own anger blazed up. He threw down the tablets he had been holding and shattered them at the base of the mountain. Seizing the calf he melted it in the fire and ground it into powder, which he scattered on the water. Then he made the people of Israel drink it. Moshe said to Aaron, what did these people do to you to make you lead them in such a terrible sin? Aaron replied, my Lord shouldn't be so angry. You know how these people are like. They're so determined to do evil. So they said to me, make us gods to go ahead of us, because this Moshe, the man that brought us up from the land of Egypt, we don't know what became of him. I answered them and everyone with gold, strip it off. So they gave it to me. I threw it in the fire and out came this calf. Then Moshe saw that the people had gotten out of control because Aaron had allowed them to get out of control to the derision of their enemies. Amen?
Amen.
Great story, Aaron.
Gran historia, Aaron.
Great.
Gran historia.
Now let's take a look at this.
Ahora veamos a esto.
When the people saw that Moshe was taking a long time to come down the mountain, they gathered. Verse 1. When the people saw that Moshe was taking a long time to come down from the mountain, they gathered around Aaron and said to him, "Get busy and make us gods to go ahead of us, because this Moshe, the man that brought us up from the land of Egypt, we don't know what became of him." Amen? So we see very clearly here from verse 1.
Vemos aquí muy claramente del verso 1.
That they left Egypt.
Que ellos dejaron Egipto.
But Egypt didn't leave them.
Pero Egipto no los dejó.
You can leave the old church.
Tú puedes dejar la iglesia vieja.
You can leave the old job.
Puedes dejar el trabajo antiguo.
You can leave the bottle.
Puedes dejar la botella.
You can leave pornography.
Puedes dejar la pornografía.
Whatever it was that made you seek God.
Lo que sea que te hizo buscar a Dios.
But if your heart doesn't change,
pero si tu corazón no cambia,
then the old life has never left you.
Entonces la vida antigua nunca te dejó.
And this is what Rav Shaul was talking about in Romans.
Y eso es lo que Rav Shaul estaba hablando en Romanos.
Should you keep on sinning?
¿Deberías seguir pecando?
So that God can show you more grace?
Así Dios te muestra más gracia.
That's what the church is missing.
Eso es lo que la iglesia le falta.
That's what a large part of the messianic body is missing.
Eso es lo que la mayoría del cuerpo mesiánico le falta.
We keep sinning.
Seguimos pecando.
Yes, God does show mercy.
Sí, Dios muestra gracia.
To a point.
Hasta un punto.
When you get up to heaven.
Cuando tú subes al cielo.
And he says, "Why were you doing Christmas?"
Te dice, "¿Por qué estabas celebrando Navidad?"
"Why were you doing Sunday worship?"
¿Por qué estabas adorando el domingo?
And you're going to say, "Well, my pastor said."
Tú le vas a decir, bueno, mi pastor me dijo.
That Messiah rose from the grave on Sunday.
Que el Mesías se levantó de la tumba el
domingo.
Right,
didn't they say that to you, Maria?
Te dijeron así, ¿verdad?
It was a holy day.
Era un día santo.
It's the first day of the week.
Es el primer día de la semana.
All Jews go back to work on the
Todos
first day of the week.
Todos los judíos regresan a trabajar el primer día de la semana.
Today we go back to work.
Es el día que regresan a trabajar.
So if you go on sinning.
Si sigues pecando,
when you get to heaven,
cuando subas al
what's
cielo,
God going to say to you?
¿Qué te va a decir Dios?
Well, you know, the pastor said we need to do Sundays.
El pastor me dijo que teníamos que hacer los domingos.
Messiah is going to say what?
El Mesías va a decir qué?
In Matthew 5, verse 18, I said what?
En Mateo 5, verse 18, digo qué?
Not until heaven and earth pass away.
No hasta que el cielo y la tierra pasen.
Not until heaven and earth pass away.
No hasta que el cielo y la tierra pasen.
Will the law be gone?
Será la ley acabada.
But you go right back to the old life.
Pero no, I'm sorry.
You go right back to the old life.
Pero vas de vuelta a la vida antigua.
God wants you to walk away from the old life.
Dios quiere que te alejes de la vida antigua.
God wants to do something new in your life.
Dios quiere hacer algo nuevo en tu vida.
See, when people are unsure of the word of God.
Cuando la gente no está segura de la palabra de Dios.
Let me say that again.
Déjame decirlo otra vez.
When you're unsure of the word of God,
cuando no estás seguro de la palabra de Dios,
when any little trial happens,
cuando cualquier pequeña prueba sucede,
what happens to you?
¿Qué te pasa a ti?
You go right back to the old life.
Te vas de vuelta a la vida antigua.
You go right back to cursing.
Te vas de vuelta a maldecir.
See me? No, that was one of my things.
Esa era una de las cosas.
The more angrier I got,
lo más enojado que me ponía.
French fries were flowing out of my mouth.
Papas fritas salían de mi boca.
Papas fritas were frying out of my mouth.
Salían de mi boca.
Every effing word,
cualquier palabra con
every idea. Profanity came out of my mouth.
Cualquier mala palabra salía de mi boca.
Do you go back to that?
Regresas tú a eso.
Whatever your thing was,
lo que sea que haya sido tu
when
cosa,
that first trial happens,
cuando esa primera prueba sucedió,
do you want that drink?
¿Quieres esa bebida?
When that first trial happens,
cuando esa prueba pasó,
do you go shopping for another pair of shoes?
¿Vas de compras por un nuevo par de zapatos?
When that first trial happens,
cuando esa primera prueba pasa,
do you go shopping for a new pocketbook?
¿Vas de compras a una cartera?
You know, women will have 35 pairs of shoes.
Las mujeres tendrán 35 pares de zapatos.
Women will have 35 pairs of shoes.
Las mujeres tendrán 35 pares de zapatos.
Women will have 38 pairs of shoes.
Las mujeres tendrán 38 pares de zapatos.
And a lot of people, when things happen,
mucha gente cuando las cosas pasan,
I need to go shopping.
Necesito ir a compras.
I need to go shopping.
Necesito ir a compras.
Whatever it is,
lo que sea que sea.
If you're not solid on the word of God,
si no eres sólido en la palabra de Dios,
and you're not walking with God,
y no estás caminando con Dios,
you go right back to the old life.
Tú regresas de vuelta a la vida antigua.
And that's what Pesach is all about.
De eso se trata la Pascua.
Remembering putting the blood on the door.
Recuerda poner la, pusieron la sangre en la puerta.
Remember putting the blood on the door.
Recuerda pusimos la sangre en la puerta.
Chag Matzah is about remembering the time that we were in slavery.
Chag Matzah se trata de recordar el tiempo donde estábamos en esclavitud.
Chag Matzah is about remembering crossing the Red Sea.
Chag Matzah se trata de cruzar el mar de los juncos.
Look at verse 1 again.
Verso 1.
When the people saw that Moshe was taking a long time to come down from the mountain, they gathered around Aaron and said to him, "Get busy and make us gods to go ahead of us, because Moshe, the man who brought us up from the land of Egypt, we don't know what has become of him." Amen?
Amen.
Now the people say to the leader, Aaron,
ahora la gente le dice al líder, Aaron,
go make us a god that we can see.
Ve y haznos un dios que podamos ver.
Did you see a god that split the Red Sea?
¿Viste un dios que dividió el mar de los juncos?
Did you see the god that brought hail down from heaven?
¿Le viste al dios que hizo caer granizo del cielo?
Did you see the god that turned the Nile blood red?
¿Viste al dios que hizo el mar rojo como sangre?
And now,
el mar lo hizo sangre.
And now Darwin.
Y ahora.
They want to go right back to it.
Quieren regresar a eso.
Is that what happens to us?
¿Es eso lo que pasa con nosotros?
Is that what happens to us?
¿Es eso lo que pasa con nosotros?
Look at verse 3 and 4.
Verso 3 y 4.
The people stripped off their gold earrings and brought them to Aaron. He received what they gave to him and melted it down and made it into the shape of a calf. They said, "Israel, here is your God who brought you up from the land of Egypt." Amen?
Amen.
Here is your God that can't hear or speak, but praise him.
Aquí está el Dios que no puedes oír o hablar. Pero escucha, adóralo.
I just made this with my hands, but praise him.
Hice esto con mis manos, pero adóralo.
Here's the God that saved you. I just made him.
Ese es el Dios que te salvó. Aquí está.
Now, why did he make a calf?
Porque él hizo un becerro.
Because that was the God of prosperity and sexuality in Egypt.
Porque ese era el Dios de prosperidad y sexualidad en Egipto.
Walking with God.
Caminar con Dios.
Walking in this new life.
Caminar en esta nueva vida.
You should be able to tell the truth from lies.
Tú debes poder de discernir de la verdad y la mentira.
So when some Christian says,
si algún cristiano dice,
we can now eat pork.
Podemos ahora comer cerdo.
Because of Peter's vision in Acts chapter 10.
Porque la visión de Pedro en Hechos capítulo 10.
You say, did you read that part slowly?
Le dirás, ¿leíste esa parte lentamente?
Because Peter never ate the food.
Porque Pedro nunca comió la comida.
And he told whoever's ever speaking to him, no, I ain't doing that.
Y le dijo a cualquiera que está hablando con él, yo no comeré eso.
Walking in a new life.
Caminar en la nueva vida.
You should understand about truth.
Debes entender acerca de la verdad.
That you need to tell the truth.
Que necesitas decir la verdad.
And what happened in Acts chapter 5?
¿Qué pasó en Hechos 5?
What happened in Acts chapter 5?
¿Qué pasó en Hechos 5?
Peter said to the guy, "Did you sell a house for this much money?"
Pedro le dijo al hombre, "¿Vendiste esta casa por tanto y tanto dinero?"
And the man said, "Yeah, I sold it for that much."
Y el hombre dijo, "Sí, yo lo vendí tanto."
Yeah, that's the ticket. That's what I'm talking about. Yeah, de eso estoy hablando.
De eso lo hice, sí.
And he was lying. And what happened to him?
Y estaba mintiendo. ¿Qué pasó con él?
Zap, you're dead.
Se murió ese rato.
Zap, you're dead.
Un golpe y se murió.
I guess we weren't living under grace in Acts chapter 5.
Quizá no estábamos viviendo bajo gracia en Hechos 5.
And then what else happens in Acts chapter 5?
Y lo mismo pasa en Hechos 5.
His wife comes.
La esposa viene.
And Kepha, the disciple, says what?
Y Kepha, el discípulo, le dice qué?
Did you sell the house for this much money?
The property? ¿Vendiste esta propiedad por tanto y tanto dinero?
Yeah, that's the ticket.
Sí, así fue.
That's what we sold it for.
Eso es lo que dijimos.
And what does Kepha reply?
¿Y qué le dijo Pedro?
Why are you lying to the Holy Spirit?
¿Por qué le mientes al Espíritu Santo?
These men are coming back from burying your husband.
Estos hombres vienen de enterrar a tu esposo.
Now you're dead.
Ahora tú vas a morir.
And what happened to her?
¿Qué le pasó a ella?
She dropped dead.
Ella se cayó muerta.
And they buried her.
Y la enterraron.
So here, we go back to verse 3 and 4.
Aquí vamos a los versos 3 y 4.
The people stripped off their gold earrings and brought them to Aaron. He received what they gave him and melted it down made into the shape of a calf. They said, "Israel, here is your God who brought you up from the land of Egypt." Amen?
Amen.
You got to be able to tell the truth from lies.
Tienes tú que poder discernir de entre la verdad y la mentira.
God says, "Make no image about me."
Dios dice que no hagas imagen acerca de él.
But the Catholics have him on a cross.
Pero los católicos lo tienen en la cruz.
Yeshua is still on the cross in the Catholic Church.
Yeshua aún está en la cruz en la Iglesia Católica.
God said, "Don't make any images."
Dios dice, no hagas imágenes.
You got to know the truth from lies.
Tienes que saber la verdad de las mentiras.
You got to start walking in this new way of life.
Tienes que comenzar a caminar en nuestra manera
de vida. Remember walking through the 3,000 feet of water.
Recuerda caminar por esos 3,000 pies de agua.
Learning to trust God in this new life.
Aprendiendo a confiar a Dios en esta nueva vida.
That the water split apart for Jew and Gentile.
Que las aguas se dividieron para el judío y el gentil.
But when Egypt doesn't leave you.
Pero cuando Egipto no te deja.
When Egypt doesn't leave your life.
Cuando Egipto no deja tu vida.
When you don't want to cover your hair because you're married.
Cuando no quieres cubrirte el pelo porque estás casada.
And God says married women should cover their heads.
Y Dios dice que la mujer casada debe cubrirse el pelo.
In Numbers chapter 5.
En Números 5.
Then Egypt has not left your life.
Entonces Egipto no ha dejado tu vida.
And Egypt has not left your life.
Egipto no ha dejado tu vida.
You still have an idol.
Aún tienes un ídolo.
You still have an idol.
Aún tienes un ídolo.
Look at verse 6.
Veamos al verso 6.
Look at verse 6.
Verso 6.
Let's see what else had not left their life.
Veamos qué más no ha dejado nuestra vida.
Early the next morning they got up and offered burnt offerings and presented peace offerings. Afterwards, the people sat down to eat and drink. They got up to indulge in revelry. Amen? What is revelry?
¿Qué es el regocijo?
No, that's not it. What is that?
¿Qué es eso?
Well, the word you have to go back to, I'm not going to have you turn to it, but the reference is Genesis 26.
La referencia es Génesis 26, no vayan allá.
Verse 8.
Verso 8.
That same word,
esa misma palabra,
is used when Yitzhak was playing with his wife.
Esa misma palabra se utiliza cuando Yitzhak estaba jugando con su esposa.
Caressing her,
la estaba acariciando.
If you know what I mean.
Si sabes lo que digo.
It's all part of the Bible. We can talk about these things.
Es parte de la Biblia. Podemos
hablar. But it's only for a husband and wife.
Pero es solo para un esposo y una esposa.
Husbands and wives. That's
esposos
how children get made.
Y esposos. Así es como los niños
touch. Son. It's okay.
Se toca y está
but
bien.
Only between daddy and mommy.
Solo entre papá y mamá.
Okay, you'll learn about this children in marriage class when you get married someday.
Tú aprenderás eso en tu clase matrimonial cuando
it's all about the word of God.
Se trata de la palabra de Dios.
But here, Yitzhak was caressing his wife.
Yitzhak estaba acariciando a su esposa.
So now we take that understanding.
Tomamos ese entendimiento.
To Exodus 32 verse 6.
A Éxodo 32 verse 6.
They were drinking.
Estaban bebiendo.
They were eating and drinking.
Estaban comiendo y bebiendo.
And then they were partying.
Y estaban festejando.
They were partying, real partying.
Estaban festejando.
Studio 54 partying.
Fiesta de Studio 54.
They were clubbing it, baby.
Estaban celebrando.
They were indulging in fornication.
Estaban metidos en la fornicación.
Because that's what the Egyptian culture was all about.
Porque eso es lo que la cultura egipcia se trataba.
As you can see very plainly,
como puedes ver planamente,
we left Egypt.
Dejamos Egipto.
But Egypt did not leave us.
Pero Egipto no nos dejó.
So when you're walking in this new way of life,
entonces cuando estás caminando en esta nueva manera de vivir,
do you want Egypt to leave you?
¿Quieres que Egipto te deje a ti?
Then you got to start walking with God.
Y debes comenzar a caminar con Dios.
Hold your place there in Exodus.
Mantén tu lugar ahí en Éxodo.
Turn back to Romans 6, please.
Y vamos de vuelta a Romanos 6.
Anybody getting anything so far today?
¿Están entendiendo
algo? You learned something there, no way?
¿Están aprendiendo algo?
I'm going to quiz you later. I'm going to sit at your table. You learning something, Moses? Learning? Romans 6, verses 1 and 2.
Romanos 6, versos 1 y 2.
Romans 6, verse 1 and 2.
Romanos 6, verso 1 y 2.
So then, are we to say, let's keep on sinning so that there can be more grace? Heaven forbid. How can we who have died to sin still live in it? Amen?
Amen.
You can see that this is exactly what Rav Shaul is talking about.
Puedes ver aquí que eso habla Rav Shaul aquí.
How can we keep living in it?
¿Cómo podemos seguir viviendo en eso?
How can we keep living and drinking in that way of life?
¿Cómo podemos seguir viviendo y bebiendo en esa manera de vida?
How can we keep going to those same places?
Porque ¿cómo podemos seguir yendo a esos mismos lugares?
How can we be sexual animals?
¿Cómo podemos ser animales sexuales?
See, that's what Paul is talking about.
De eso habla Pablo.
Turn to Romans 1, please.
Vamos a Romanos 1.
Romans 1.
Romanos 1.
Romans 1.
Romanos 1,
verse 22 to 24.
Versos 22 al 24.
Romans 1,
Romanos 1,
verse 22 to 24.
Versos 22 al 24.
Romans 1,
Romanos 1,
verse 22 to 24.
Versos 22 al 24.
Claiming to be wise, they have become fools. In fact, they exchange the glory of an immortal God for mere images, like mortal human beings, or like birds, or animals, or reptiles. This is why God has given them up to their shameful, vile, to given them up to vileness of their hearts, lust, to the shameful misuse of each other's body. Amen?
Amen.
Once again, he's talking about Exodus 32.
Una vez más habla de Éxodo 32.
The shameful misuse of their bodies.
El uso vergonzoso de sus cuerpos.
What would that be talking about?
¿De qué estaría hablando?
They engage in revelry.
Se metían en rebeldría, juerga.
Okay.
Juerga.
They were having orgies. They were having sexual things that were bad.
Estaban teniendo orgías y cosas sexuales que eran malas.
They were making images of a cow as a god.
Hicieron imágenes de una vaca como Dios.
Shameful misuse of their bodies.
Un uso deshonroso de sus cuerpos.
What would that be?
¿Qué sería eso?
How would I know what that shameful misuse of their body
¿Cómo
would
yo
be?
Sé cuál es el uso vergonzoso de su cuerpo?
Go back to Exodus 32, verse 6.
Vamos de vuelta a Éxodo 32, verso 6.
This is what he's talking about.
Y de eso es lo que él habla.
What would be the shameful misuse of their bodies?
¿Cuál sería el uso vergonzoso de sus cuerpos?
Exodus 32, verse 6.
Éxodo 32, verso 6.
Early in the morning they got up, offered burnt offerings and presented peace offerings. Afterwards the people sat down to eat, drink, they got up to indulge in revelry. Amen?
Amen.
Indulge.
Se metieron.
What does God say to indulge in?
Que, en que es,
somebody would indulge.
Indulge.
What does God say take pleasure in?
En que debes tomar placer.
What does God say take a lot of, do a lot things with?
Hacer muchas cosas.
His word.
En su palabra.
Indulge in God's word. Delve into God's word.
Meter, estar en la palabra de Dios.
Look at the verse again. Look at verse 6 again.
Verso 6.
Okay. Early in the morning, they got up, offered burnt offerings, and presented peace offerings. Afterwards, the people sat down to eat and drink. They got up to indulge in revelry. Amen?
Amen.
They turned aside from following God already.
Se alejaron de Dios ya.
What we're to do is one step forward each day.
Lo que debemos hacer es dar un paso adelante cada día.
What would happen?
¿Qué pasaría?
Picture the water again.
Tomemos el ejemplo del agua otra vez.
You know, there are some people that just like to dive into the ocean, right?
Es como la gente que le gusta entrar en el océano.
How many people here, if you ever go to a pool?
¿Cuántos se han ido a una piscina?
How many people just do this with their foot first?
¿Cuántos hacen esto con su pie primero?
They put the one foot in first. How many people go to where the stairs are? One step at a time.
Ooh,
it's cold.
Tiene frío, está frío.
How many people are like, all right, just jump right on in?
Okay, voy a saltar.
Oh, you're Mets and Mets, Danny? He's like, hey, just jump in, man. Just jump in.
Solo salta.
Same way with God.
Lo mismo con Dios.
Are you the one that just does this?
Es aquel que hace esto.
See if you can trust God.
A ver si puedes confiar en Dios.
What if the people of God,
¿qué si la gente de Dios,
with the water walled up on either side of them,
con el agua en los dos lados como una pared,
what if they had done just that?
Como si hubieran hecho eso.
What if they got halfway into the Red Sea?
¿Qué pasa si entraban a la mitad
del mar? What if they had done that?
¿Qué pasó?
Are you the same way?
¿Eres tú de la misma
Are
manera?
You the same way?
Eres tú de la misma manera.
Look at verse 8.
Verso 8.
So quickly they have turned aside from the way I ordered them to follow. They have cast metal statue of a calf, worshipped it, sacrificed to it, and said, Israel, here is your Elohim who brought you up from the land of Egypt. Amen?
Amen.
Are you like this?
Eres tú así.
A new way of life shouldn't be like this.
Una nueva manera de vivir no debería ser así.
Once you leave Egypt, leave Egypt.
Una vez que te vas de Egipto, vete de Egipto.
If God says for women to cover their hair, cover your hair.
Si Dios dice que las mujeres deben cubrirse el pelo,
if God says to grow your beard, grow your beard.
Si Dios dice que debes dejarte crecer la barba, déjate
la God
crecer.
Says don't cut your beard, don't cut your beard.
Si Dios dice no te cortes la barba, no te cortes la barba.
If God says to be here on the holy days,
si Dios dice que estés aquí en los días santos,
being at home unless you're in a hospital bed is not okay.
Estar en tu casa, no ser que estés en un hospital, no está bien.
There is no excuse, period.
No hay excusa, punto aparte.
But so quickly we want those blessings. How many people want those blessings?
Pero tan pronto queremos bendiciones.
I want blessings from God. I want blessings from God. More and more blessings.
Yo quiero bendiciones de Dios más y más.
But here you get so far in God.
Aquí tú te alejas tanto de Dios.
And then you turn around.
Y después das la vuelta.
Oh, maybe I can call those old people at the old church.
Quizá voy a llamar a esa gente de la iglesia.
Tell them the truth.
Decirles la verdad.
And then they start drawing you back, right back there.
Y te comienzan a llamar otra vez.
This is what was happening to Jew and Gentile in verse 8.
Eso es lo que estaba pasando con judío y gentil en el verso 8.
So quickly they turn aside.
Tan rápido ellos se regresaron.
Oh, if I take off the seventh day of Hag Matzah,
si tomo libre el séptimo día de Hag Matzah,
my boss is going to fire me.
Mi jefe me va a despedir.
God's not going to let things happen to you.
Dios no va a dejar que las cosas pasen
unless
a
he's
ti.
Got something better for you.
A no ser que él tenga algo mejor para ti.
I can't take the Sabbath off.
No puedo tomar el sábado
libre.
They'll fire
me from work.
Me despedirán del trabajo.
Is not God the God of all creation?
No es Dios el Dios de toda la creación.
Is not God who put a baby inside the mother's womb?
No es Dios el que pone a un bebé dentro del vientre materno.
Is not the God of all creation.
No es él el Dios de toda la creación.
But you're not trusting.
No estás confiando.
You're not walking in a new life.
No estás caminando en una nueva vida.
This is why God gives us the holy days.
Por eso es que Dios nos da los días santos.
Because a lot of times life gets busy.
Porque muchas veces la vida se pone
God
ocupada.
God gives us these pauses.
Dios nos da estas pausas.
Remember, you walked on dry ground.
Recuerda que caminaste en tierra seca.
Remember, they drowned.
Recuerda, ellos se ahogaron.
Remember, I chose you.
Recuerda, yo te escogí.
You're his.
Eres de él.
But quickly we forget the bonds of slavery.
Pero rápidamente nos olvidamos de la esclavitud.
Quickly we go back to fornication.
Rápidamente vamos a la fornicación.
Quickly we go back to loving money.
Rápidamente regresamos a amar el dinero.
Quickly we go back to gossiping.
Rápidamente vamos otra vez al chisme.
Quickly we think we know more than the rabbi.
Rápidamente pensamos que sabemos más que el rabino.
Quickly we start doing things against the word of God.
Rápidamente comenzamos a hacer cosas en contra de la palabra de Dios.
Quickly we stop trusting in the commandments of God.
Rápidamente dejamos de confiar en los mandamientos de Dios.
Go to Exodus 32, please.
Vámonos a Éxodo 32.
Exodus 32, verse 21 and 22.
Éxodo 32, versos 21 y 22.
Exodus 32.
Éxodo 32.
Verse 21 and 22.
Verso 21 y 22.
Moshe said, Aaron, what did these people do to make you lead them into such a terrible sin? Aaron replied, my Lord shouldn't be so angry. You know what these people are like. They're so determined to do evil. Amen?
Amen.
Here, the leader is like lying.
Aquí el líder está mintiendo.
Like Aaron just like, you know, he didn't leave Egypt.
Aaron tampoco dejó Egipto.
Moses, these people, you know how these people are.
Moisés, tú sabes cómo es esta gente.
They're holding a gun to my head, man.
Me estaban apuntando con una pistola.
They're holding a sword to my throat.
Me pusieron una espada en el cuello.
They were trying to cut my beard.
Estaban tratando de cortar mi barba.
They were trying to cut it off.
Estaban tratando de cortarla.
But he quickly lies.
Rápidamente él mintió.
Is that what happens to you?
¿Es eso lo que te pasa a ti?
When in doubt, lie.
No mentías.
When in doubt, lie.
No sería eso mentir.
The holy days remind us, stop walking in that.
Los días santos nos ayudan a
walk in the truth.
A caminar en la verdad.
The holy days are over now.
Los días santos han terminado.
Do you go right back to following your old nature?
Te vas de vuelta a seguir tu naturaleza antigua.
Look at verse 22 again.
Verso 22 otra vez.
Aaron replied, my Lord shouldn't be so angry. You know what these people are like. They are determined to do evil. Amen? Amen. Are you determined to do evil?
¿Estás tú determinado a hacer maldad?
Are you determined to do evil?
¿Estás tú determinado a hacer maldad?
I'm not determined to do evil.
Yo no estoy determinado a hacer maldad.
Are you determined to do evil?
¿Estás determinado a hacer maldad?
Are you determined to do evil?
¿Estás determinado a hacer maldad?
Cutting your beard, men, will be determined to do evil.
Cortarse la barba a los hombres es determinado a hacer maldad.
Because God said in the book of Leviticus, don't cut your beards.
Porque Dios dice en el libro de Levítico, no te cortes la
barba. To God, cutting a beard and coveting a woman's body is the same thing.
Para Dios, cortarte la barba y codiciar a una mujer es lo mismo.
It's not as far as homosexuality.
No es tan lejos como el homosexualismo.
But are you determined to do evil?
Pero estás determinado a hacer la maldad.
Well, what is evil?
¿Qué es maldad?
Everybody now for all the new people.
Todos ahora.
Seis uno tres. Seis uno tres. Seis uno tres. 613 laws tells you what evil is.
Las 613 leyes te avisan que es malvado.
Or are you determined to get to the promised land?
¿O estás determinado a llegar a la tierra prometida?
I'm determined to get to the promised land.
Estoy determinado a llegar a la tierra prometida.
And how do you get to the promised land?
¿Cómo llego a la tierra prometida?
You follow your GPS.
Sigues tu GPS.
How do you get to the promised land?
¿Cómo llegas a la tierra
prometida? You follow God's GPS.
Sigues el guiador de Dios.
And what is God's GPS?
¿Y cuál es el guiador de Dios?
God's perfect system.
El sistema perfecto de Dios.
What is God's perfect system?
¿Cuál es el sistema perfecto
de Dios? 613. 613.
613.
613. That's what his perfect system is.
Ese es el sistema perfecto.
Are you determined?
¿Estás determinado?
Are you resolute?
¿Estás decidido?
I'm going to get there.
Voy a llegar allá.
I'm unwavering.
Estoy
nobody's going to push me either way.
No me voy a dejar empujar por nadie.
See, when somebody comes to you, well, we should do it this way.
Si alguien te dice, debemos hacerlo de esta manera.
Or we should do it this way.
O de esta manera.
Or that's for the Jews.
Eso es para los judíos.
Or we can eat pork now.
O podemos comer cerdo ahora.
We can celebrate Christmas now.
Podemos celebrar Navidad ahora.
We can make up holidays.
Podemos hacer los días santos.
No! Unwavering.
Que no estás, no te vas a dejar llevar.
Means I am determined to get to the promised land.
Significa que estás determinado para llegar a la tierra prometida.
This is why Yeshua the Messiah said, "Follow me."
Eso es lo que Yeshua el Mesías dice, sígueme.
How many Christmases did Yeshua celebrate?
¿Cuántas Navidades Yeshua celebró?
How many ham sandwiches did Yeshua eat?
¿Cuántos sándwiches de jamón comió Yeshua?
He didn't like the pig so much he sent them over the hill.
Él no le gustó tanto el cerdo que les mandó a la, por, abajo de la quebrada.
Remember, he sent the demons into the pigs, right?
Él mandó a los cerdos al abismo.
And what happened to the pigs?
¿Y qué pasó con los cerdos?
Look at all that ham sandwiches.
Mira todos esos sándwiches de jamón.
Look at verse 22.
Verso 22.
Aaron replied, "My Lord shouldn't be so angry. You know what these people are like. They are determined to do evil." Amen.
Amen.
Are you determined to do good?
¿Estás tú determinado a hacer el bien?
How will I know good?
¿Cómo es que yo sé el bien?
Yeshua's example.
Por medio del ejemplo de Yeshua.
How will I know what is evil?
¿Cómo yo sé que es malvado?
Judas's example.
El ejemplo de Judas.
Let's look at verse 24 and 25.
Veamos los versos 24 y 25.
Exodus 32, verse 24, 25.
Éxodo 32, 24 y 25.
I answered them, "Anyone with gold, strip it off." So they gave it to me. I threw it in the fire, and out came this calf. When Moshe saw that the people had gotten out of control because Aaron allowed them to get out of control to the derision of the enemies. Amen?
Amen.
Sometimes even leaders.
Hay veces que incluso los líderes.
You know, Aaron's like, you know, I threw the gold in.
Aaron dice, puse el oro en la olla.
And it just popped out.
Y salió de ahí.
Yeah, I see it too, Aaron.
Yo también lo veo, Aaron.
Yeah, I see it, Aaron.
También lo veo, Aaron.
I see it.
También lo veo.
See, sometimes leaders go bad too.
Hay veces que los líderes también les va mal.
There's a lot of leaders that are still pastors that are divorced.
Hay muchos líderes o pastores que están divorciados.
You can't be divorced and be a pastor.
Tú no puedes estar divorciado y ser un pastor.
You can't be a woman and be a pastor.
No puedes ser una mujer y ser
pastor. And a divorced woman three times.
Y hay mujeres divorciadas tres veces.
Paula White, married Paula three White. Times.
Casada tres veces.
Three times.
Tres veces.
35,000 people going to her demonically possessed church.
35,000 personas van a su iglesia satánica.
And she's just like Aaron. It just popped out.
Ella es como Aaron. Salió de ahí.
I said, I do. It just popped out.
Dije, lo haré, y salió de ahí.
You got to follow the word of God in this new life.
Tienes que seguir la palabra de Dios en esta vida nueva.
Turn to Luke, Gospel of Luke.
Vámonos al Evangelio de Lucas.
This is going to hit you real hard now.
Esto te va a golpear muy duro.
The Gospel of Luke, chapter 9.
El Evangelio de Lucas, capítulo 9.
Anybody learning anything so far today?
Aprendido algo hoy.
Amen. Luke chapter 9.
Lucas capítulo 9.
Verse 57 through 62.
Versos 57 al 62.
Wait till you see what Yeshua says.
Prepárate para ver lo que dice Yeshua.
Might want to take notes, kids. There'll be questions on this one. Okay. Luke chapter 9, verse 57 through 62.
Lucas capítulo 9, versos 57 al 62.
Luke chapter 9, verse 57 through 62.
Lucas capítulo 9, versos 57 al 62.
This section is called, Do You Look Back?
Esta sección se titula, ¿Es mira usted hacia atrás?
As they were traveling on the road, a man said to him, I will follow you wherever you go. Yeshua answered him, The foxes have holes, the birds flying about have nests. But the Son of Man has no home of his own. Another said to another, he said, Follow me, sígueme. But the man replied, Sir, first let me go and bury my father. Yeshua said, Let the dead bury their own dead. You go and proclaim the kingdom of Elohim. Yet another said, I will follow you, sir. But first let me say goodbye to the people at home. To him Yeshua said, No one puts his hand to the plow and keeps looking back is fit to serve the kingdom of Elohim. Amen. Let's look at verse 62. You might want to underline it in your Bible.
Veamos al verso 62 y quizá lo quieran señalar en sus Biblias.
To him, Yeshua said, No one who puts his hand to the plow and keeps looking back is fit to serve the kingdom of Elohim. Amen. Amen. See, when you're driving a plow,
cuando estás en un guiando un arado,
and you keep looking back,
y sigues mirando hacia atrás.
Your plow's going all over the field.
Tu arado se va a ir en todo, va a estar en todo el campo.
See those spring holy days.
Esos fiestas de primavera.
Teach us to keep your eyes forward.
Nos enseñan a mantener nuestros ojos derechos.
Because remember, we're walking through the water.
Porque recuerda que estamos caminando en el agua.
We're going through the Reed Sea.
Estamos caminando por el mar
Luz,
de los juncos.
There's 3,000 feet of water.
Son 3,000 pies de agua.
3,000, Elmira, 3,000 feet of water. David.
3,000 pies de agua.
3,000 feet of water. Moses, 3,000 feet of water.
Son 3,000 pies de agua.
If you keep looking back,
si sigues mirando,
you walk right into the water.
Vas a chocarte con el agua.
Yeshua is saying, keep your eyes forward.
Yeshua dice, sigue tus ojos, mantén tus ojos derechos.
Once you leave the old life.
Una vez que dejas la vida antigua.
Once you leave the old life.
Una vez que dejas la vida antigua.
Don't say, I want to go back there no more.
No digas que quieres regresar allá.
Once you walk with God, walk with God.
Una vez que caminas con Dios, camina con Dios.
Because nobody who puts their hands to the plow.
Porque nadie que pone su mano en el arado.
Keeps looking on back.
Sigue mirando hacia atrás.
Once you look back, you take your hands off the plow.
Una vez que miras hacia atrás, quitas tus manos del arado.
And what does verse 62 say?
¿Y qué dice el verso 62?
You're not fit.
No eres apto.
To serve the kingdom of God.
Para servir al reino de Dios.
And if you're not fit.
¿Y si no eres apto?
Do you really think you're going to get into the promised land?
¿Crees realmente que vas a entrar a la tierra prometida?
You got to keep walking.
Tienes que seguir caminando.
The word of God says to do something, do it.
Si la palabra de Dios te dice que hagas algo, hazlo.
But I can't do it.
No puedo hacerlo.
I can't put the seat on.
No me puedo poner los seat.
What are the guys at work going to say about me?
Se van a decir los hombres en el trabajo acerca de mí.
They're going to make fun of me.
Se van a burlar de mí.
I can't cover my hair.
No me puedo cubrir el cabello.
I can stop eating pork.
Quizá voy a comer pork.
There's always something else to eat.
Si hay algo más que puedes comer.
But I can't take my jewelry off.
Pero no me puedo quitar la joyería.
I can't take my earrings off. I'm a slave to fashion.
No me puedo quitar los aretes. Soy un esclavo de la moda.
I can't do it. I can't take my lipstick off. My lips are pale.
No me puedo quitar el lápiz labial. Mis labios son pálidos.
I can't stop doing my hair in the morning.
Yo no puedo dejar de arreglarme mi pelo en la mañana.
I can't stop doing it.
No puedo dejar de hacerlo.
I can't. I need my earrings. It makes me who I am.
Necesito mis aretes. Eso me hace mi persona.
I need my jewelry.
Necesito mi joyería.
It's who I am.
Es quien soy yo.
Put your hands to the plow.
Pon tus manos en el arado.
And keep walking forward.
Y sigue caminando.
Look at verse 62.
Verso 62.
To him Yeshua said, no one puts his hand to the plow and keeps looking back is fit to serve the kingdom of God. Amen? Amen. God doesn't think you're fit if you're doing all this stuff.
Dios no cree que eres apto si estás haciendo estas cosas.
But look at verse 57.
Pero mira el verso 57.
Look at 57.
Mira el verso 57.
As they were traveling on the road, a man said to him, I will follow you wherever you go, but... There's always that but.
Siempre hay ese pero.
There's always that but.
Siempre hay ese pero.
People will always make excuses.
Gente siempre tiene excusas.
I'm not ready.
No estoy listo.
I can't do that.
No puedo hacer eso.
Why don't you just tell God, says, I don't want to do it.
¿Qué tal si Dios dice, no quiero hacerlo?
Be honest with God.
Sé honesto con Dios.
God doesn't want you lukewarm, because what happens to lukewarm?
Dios no te quiere tibio, porque ¿qué pasa si eres tibio?
What happens to lukewarm, Carmen?
¿Qué pasa si eres tibio?
Blah!
Te vomitará.
You want God vomiting you out?
¿Quieres que Dios te vomite?
Tell God, no, I'm not doing that.
Dile a Dios, no, no, yo no.
I am not covering my head.
Yo no me cubro mi cabeza.
I told God that for a long time.
Yo le dije a Dios eso por mucho
tiempo. I'm cutting
tiempo.
My beard. I hate the way this looks.
Yo me corto mi barba. No me gusta la manera.
Wakes you up in the middle of the night, right, guys?
Te despierta en medio de la noche.
You turn over. Oh, who's choking me?
Te das la vuelta.
You get up ready to fight, and you're choking yourself.
Te preparas tú mismo para pelear y te estás ahogando.
I fought with God. I told God, I'm not cutting it.
Yo le dije a Dios, yo
and God said, I'm not making the congregation any bigger. Now, if everybody was here, we'd be five rows past the end already.
Si todos estuvieran aquí, ya hubiéramos pasado.
If Martin and them come back, we'd have to put another. There are more people that just came in.
Welcome to Beth-Cohen.
But we always make excuses.
Pero siempre tenemos excusas.
Are you the king of excuses?
Eres tú el rey de las excusas.
Are you the king of excuses? But
eres
but Lord.
El rey de las excusas.
But Lord, maybe pero you're polite
Señor.
To God.
Pero Señor,
but Lord,
pero Señor,
you don't know what it's like.
Tú no sabes cómo es esto.
This is why Yeshua came.
Para eso es que vino Yeshua.
This is why Yeshua came to live here as a man.
Por eso vino Yeshua a vivir como un hombre.
Do you think there were not pretty women in Yeshua's time?
¿Crees tú que no había mujeres hermosas en el tiempo de
Yeshua?
You know,
the Roman women walking around.
Las mujeres romanas caminando.
Oh. 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 Hi, Frankie. Hi, Frankie. You're looking so nice. Do you think that there weren't gay people in Yeshua's time?
¿Crees que no hubieran homosexuales en tiempo de Yeshua?
That's why Paul wrote it in Romans.
Por eso Pablo lo escribió en Romanos.
There were homosexuals in Yeshua's time.
¿Hubieron homosexuales en tiempo de Yeshua?
He came here to be just like one of us.
Él vino a ser aquí uno como nosotros.
So you can't say nobody knows. The trouble I've seen.
Así no puedes decir tú, nadie sabe el
Yeshua's had troubles.
Yeshua tenía problemas.
He was constantly fighting with the government.
Constantemente estaba peleando con el gobierno.
You guys just don't know.
Ustedes no saben.
Look at verse 59.
Verso 59.
To another he said, follow me. But the man replied, sir, first let me go away and bury my father. Amen? Amen?
Amen. Amen.
Another excuse.
Otra excusa.
I'd like to follow you, Yeshua, but I got to go bury somebody.
Me gustaría seguirte, Yeshua, pero tengo que enterrar a alguien.
You raise your hand. How many people want blessings?
¿Cuántos quieren bendiciones?
How many people want blessings?
¿Cuántos quieren bendiciones?
How many people want blessings?
¿Cuántos quieren bendiciones?
You want blessings, Tiffany?
¿Quieren bendiciones?
Or do you like cramps?
¿O te gustan los...
Okay. How many people want blessings?
¿Cuántos quieren bendiciones?
How many people want double blessings?
¿Cuántos quieren doble bendiciones?
I want double blessings.
Yo quiero doble bendición.
Then stop making excuses.
Entonces deja poner excusas.
Amen. Sucker, Amen. Real gin, real good. But that's the word of God.
Pero es la palabra de Dios.
Well, first let me go bury my dad.
Primero déjame ir a enterrar a mi padre.
Yeshua said, follow me.
Yeshua dijo, sígueme.
Digo, sígueme.
Sígame.
Sígueme. Sígueme. I like that one. Sígueme. Real quick. Sígueme. What happened on Hag Matzah?
¿Qué pasó en Hag Matzah?
Of those that didn't follow God.
De aquellos que no siguieron a Dios.
What happened to the Egyptians?
¿Qué pasó con los egipcios?
They died.
Murieron.
Do you think you're any different than the Egyptians?
¿Crees tú que eres algo diferente que los egipcios?
Do you think you're any different than the Egyptians?
¿Crees que eres algo diferente de los egipcios?
Do you think you're any different than the world during the time of Noah?
¿Crees que eres diferente en el tiempo del mundo? ¿Crees que el mundo era diferente en tiempo de Noé?
Look at verse 61, please.
Vamos al verso 61.
Yet another said, I will follow you, sir, but first let me say goodbye to the people at home. Amen?
Amen.
Let me say goodbye to those church people before I leave.
Déjame decir adiós a la gente de la iglesia.
Let me say goodbye to them.
Déjame decirles adiós.
They've been so nice to me.
Han sido tan buenos conmigo.
I'm leaving because I'm telling you you're wrong.
Me estoy yendo porque te
I'm going to follow the Bible and you're not.
Voy a seguir la Biblia y tú no.
But then they're going to pull you on back.
Te van a llamar de vuelta.
Follow God.
Sigue a Dios.
Follow God.
Sigue a Dios.
Do the holy days.
A los días santos.
Don't give him excuses.
No les des excusas.
But after Hag Matzah.
Pero después de Hag Matzah.
After yesterday's seventh day of Hag Matzah.
Después de ayer, el séptimo día de Hag Matzah.
It's the time that we begin to walk into the desert.
Es el tiempo que comenzamos a caminar en el desierto con Dios.
Today is the day.
El día de hoy es el día.
You might want to write this down, kids. Today is the day.
El día de hoy es.
That we began to walk with God.
El día que comenzamos a caminar con Dios.
Let me say that again.
Déjame decir otra vez.
Today is the day.
El día de hoy es el día.
That we began to walk alone with God.
Que comenzamos a caminar con Dios.
What
solos.
Do you do?
¿Qué es lo que haces tú?
Are you walking in the new life?
Estás caminando en la nueva vida.
Look at verse 62, everybody.
Veamos al verso 62.
Look at verse 62.
Verso 62.
To him, Yeshua said, no one who puts the hand to the plow and keeps looking back is fit to serve the kingdom of God. Amen?
Amen.
Choose this day whom you're going to serve.
Escoge en este día a quien tú vas a servir.
How many people want a new life?
¿Cuántos quieren una nueva vida?
How many people want this new life?
¿Cuántos quieren esta nueva vida?
Then walk in God.
Entonces caminen en
Luz,
Dios.
Do you want this new life?
¿Quieres esta nueva vida?
Do you want a new life?
¿Quieres una nueva vida?
Or do you want to go back to Egypt? It's okay.
¿O quieres regresar a Egipto?
You want to go back to the other church? They're nice people.
¿Quieres ir de vuelta a la otra iglesia?
They're really nice people,
bonita.
Weren't they?
Hay gente
nice
bonita.
Nice place to worship.
Un lugar
David,
bonito
wasn't
para
a nice place for a good worship, right?
No era un bonito
nice
lugar
people,
para
right? And you can no speak just Spanish.
Pueden hablar español.
Okay. It's nice, really nice.
Muy bonito.
You okay, little Taco Bell? Burritos. Tacos. And fuego! You know? It's easier.
Es fácil.
But choose this day.
Pero escoge este día.
God took us by the hand.
Dios nos tomó de la mano.
When we left Egypt.
Cuando dejamos Egipto.
Yeshua is saying, put your hands to the plow.
Yeshua dice, pon las manos en el arado.
And walk with him.
Y camina con él.
Serve him.
Sírvele.
For time is short.
Porque el tiempo es corto.
You saw the news, everybody.
Vieron las noticias.
The UN wants to take part of Israel away from them.
Las Naciones Unidas quieren quitar parte de Israel.
War is coming.
La guerra está viniendo.
War is coming.
La guerra se está acercando.
It'll come shortly, people.
Va a venir en un tiempo.
And what did Yeshua say?
¿Y qué dijo Yeshua?
Like a thief in the night.
Como el ladrón en la noche.
Why is it a thief in the night?
¿Por qué es ladrón en la noche?
Because you're not paying attention.
Porque no estás poniendo atención.
Put your hands to the plow.
Pon tus manos en el arado.
And don't look back.
Y no mires hacia atrás.
If Yeshua did it, you do it.
Si Yeshua lo hizo, tú lo haces.
Turn to Genesis 19.
Vamos a Génesis 19.
Genesis 19.
Génesis 19.
Let's see what happens when you look back.
Veamos qué pasa cuando miras hacia atrás.
Genesis 19. Let's see what happens when you look back, Gabriel.
Génesis 19. Miremos qué pasa cuando regresas a ver atrás.
Let's see what happens when you look back.
Veamos qué pasa cuando
Genesis
miras hacia
19.
Atrás.
Genesis 19.
Génesis 19.
Verse 17 through 26.
Versos 17 al 26.
What happens when you look on back?
¿Qué pasa cuando regresas a mirar atrás?
When God gives you an order,
cuando Dios te da un orden,
and you look back,
y miras de vuelta,
what happens to you?
¿Qué pasa contigo?
Genesis 19, verse 17 through 26.
Génesis 19, versos 17 al 26.
When they brought them out, he said, "Flee for your life. Don't look behind you. And don't stop anywhere in the plain, but escape to the hills. Otherwise, you will be swept away." Lot said to them, "Please, no, my Lord. Here your servant has already found favor in your sight, and you have shown even greater mercy in saving my life. But I can't escape to the hills because I'm afraid. Disaster will overtake me, and I will die. Look, there's a town nearby to flee to. It's a small one. Please let me escape there. Isn't it just a small one? And that way I will stay alive." He replied, "All right, I agree to what you have asked. I won't overthrow the city of which you have spoken. Hurry and escape to that place, because I can't do anything until you arrive there. For this reason, the city is named Zoar, small." By the time Lot had come to Zoar, the sun had risen over the land. Then Adonai and I caused sulfur and fire to rain down upon Sodom and Amor from Jehovah out of the sky. He overthrew those cities and the entire plain and all the inhabitants of the cities and everything growing in the ground. But his wife looked back from behind him and she became a column of salt. Amen. What happens when you look back?
¿Qué pasa cuando miras atrás?
You get dead.
Te mueres.
Let's look at verse 17.
Vamos al verso 17.
Because this was the warning.
Porque esta era la advertencia.
When they had brought them out, he said, "Flee for your life. Don't look behind you. And don't stop anywhere in the plain, but escape to the hills. Otherwise, you will be swept away." Amen? Mm. God's giving you a warning.
Dios te está dando una advertencia.
What did Yeshua say?
¿Qué le dijo Yeshua?
Put your hands to the plow.
Pon tus manos en el arado.
Don't look back.
No mires hacia atrás.
Why, Frank, was he telling them not to look back?
¿Por qué diría que no regreses hacia atrás?
Because you're going to die.
Porque vas a morir.
You're not following God's will, you're going to die.
No estás siguiendo la voluntad de Dios, vas a morir.
Yeshua said, put your hands to the plow.
Yeshua dijo, pon tus manos en el arado.
Why did he say that?
¿Por qué dijo eso?
David, 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 David. We got four Davids, three roses, and a partridge in a pear tree. Why did he say, don't look back?
¿Por qué dice que no regreses a mirar atrás?
Because he's talking about Lot's wife.
Porque está hablando de la esposa de Lot.
When you get look back.
Cuando tú miras atrás.
I have excuses to look back.
Tengo excusas para mirar hacia atrás.
I have excuses to go back there.
Tengo excusas para regresar allá.
Yeshua says, follow me.
Yeshua dice, sígueme.
If he's leading you.
Si él te está guiando.
And you're looking back.
Y tú estás mirando hacia atrás.
Are you looking at the word?
¿Estás tú mirando la palabra?
Because Yeshua is the word.
Porque Yeshua es la palabra.
But if you turn around, you're not looking at the word anymore.
Pero si tú miras al otro lado, no estás mirando la palabra.
You're walking in the word.
Estás caminando en la palabra.
You're following the one who died for you.
Estás siguiendo al que murió por ti.
But as soon as you take off your eyes off the word.
Pero tan pronto que tú quitas las manos,
you take your eyes off the word,
de la palabra.
What happened to Kepha?
¿Qué le pasó a Kepha?
He's walking on the water, right?
Estuvo caminando en el
He's
agua.
Walking on the water, right?
Estuvo caminando
yeah,
en
this
agua.
Is cool. I'm walking on water.
Esto se ve bien. Estoy caminando
but then he started
agua.
To look around.
Pero comenzó Luz, a mirar
he
alrededor.
Started to look around.
Comenzó a mirar alrededor.
He started to look around.
Comenzó a mirar alrededor.
And then what happened to him?
¿Y qué le pasó a él?
Help me, Lord, I'm drowning.
Ayúdame, Señor, me ahogo.
He took his eyes off the word.
Él quitó sus ojos de la palabra.
When you take your eyes off the word,
cuando quitas los ojos de la palabra,
you die.
Tú mueres.
You die.
Mueres.
You die.
Tú mueres.
Look at verse 26. What happened?
Vamos al verso 26. ¿Qué pasó?
But his wife looked back from behind him and she became a column of salt. She was a failure.
Ella era una falla.
She was a failure.
Fue una falla.
Do you want to be a failure?
¿Quieres tú ser un fracaso?
How many people you want to be a failure?
¿Cuántos quieren ser un fracaso?
Yeah, that's what I aspire to, man.
Eso es lo que yo busco.
I want to be the world's biggest failure.
Yo quiero ser el fracaso más grande del
that
mundo.
That would be called Donald Trump.
Eso será llamado Donald Trump.
Okay? I want to be the world's biggest failure.
Quiero ser el
Wait,
fracaso
one
más grande
marriage,
del mundo.
Two marriages?
Un matrimonio, dos matrimonios?
You think your third wife married you for your looks, Donald?
¿Crees que tu tercera esposa se casó por lo cómo te mirabas?
Nice. What happens when you don't follow God's word?
¿Qué pasa cuando no sigues la palabra de Dios?
You become a failure.
te conviertes en un fracaso.
Destruction of your life.
La destrucción de tu vida.
And what happens also?
Y lo que pasa también.
What happened to Lot's family after
¿qué
this?
¿Qué pasó con la familia de Lot después de esto?
What happened to Lot's family?
¿Qué pasó con la familia de Lot?
You know, they went to that little town.
Fueron a esa pequeña ciudad.
And Lot was so much in despair.
Y Lot estaba tan desesperado.
He started to drink.
Que comenzó a beber.
And then what happened one night?
¿Qué pasó una noche?
His daughters got him drunk.
Sus hijas lo emborracharon.
He had sex with one of his kids.
Y tuvo sexo con
sus
hijos.
Gross.
Desagradable.
Ew.
Repugnante.
But he didn't just do it once.
Pero no lo hizo una vez.
The next night, the second daughter gets him drunk.
La segunda noche la otra hija la emborracha.
This is all in the Bible, guys.
Todo está en la Biblia.
And then he has sex with his second daughter.
Y tiene sexo con la otra hija.
All because his wife.
Todo porque su esposa
failed.
Falló.
See, God made them male and female.
Dios los hizo hombre y mujer.
Husband and wife are supposed to be together.
Esposo y esposa deben estar juntos.
Husband and wife are supposed to help one another.
Esposo y esposa se supone que deben
ayudarse. That's why Chava was pulled from his side.
Por eso es que Chava fue sacada de su costado.
To be his helpmate.
Para ser su ayudante.
Not so he should stand on her.
No para que él se pare sobre ella.
Not from his head so that she should be over him.
No sobre su cabeza para que él esté, ella esté sobre él.
But his side.
Pero su costado.
So she failed.
Ella fracasó.
Then the whole family failed.
Y toda la familia fracasó.
Because we survived together.
Porque sobrevivimos juntos.
As a family.
Como una familia.
And we die together when there's sin in the camp.
Y morimos juntos cuando hay pecado en el campo. En el
We're
campamento.
Supposed to be salt and light, everybody.
Se supone que debemos ser sal y luz.
And that's what Yeshua said in Matthew 5.
Y eso es lo que Yeshua dijo en Mateo 5.
In verse 13 and 14.
En verso 3 y 14.
We're supposed to be salt and light.
Se supone que debemos ser sal y luz.
We're supposed to die to self.
Debemos morir en nosotros mismos.
And live for God.
Y vivir para Dios.
Turn to Philippians 3, please.
Vamos a Filipenses 3.
Philippians 3.
Filipenses 3.
Anybody learning anything here today? Amen.
Aprendiendo algo hoy.
Learning something there, Felix? You learning something? Jorge, you learning something? Philippians 3, everybody.
Filipenses 3.
Verse 12 through 14.
Versos 3, no, 12 al 14.
12 through 14.
Filipenses 3, verso 12 al 14.
This is, part is called pursuing the goal.
Esta parte se titula Alcanzando el Objetivo.
Philippians 3.
Filipenses 3.
Verse 12 through 14.
Versos 12 al 14.
Philippians 3.
Filipenses 3.
Verse 12 through 14.
Versos 12 al 14.
It is not that I've already obtained it or already reached the goal. No. I keep pursuing it in the hope of taking hold of what of that for which the Messiah Yeshua took hold of me. Brothers, I for my part do not think of myself of having yet gotten hold of it. But one thing I do, forgetting what is behind me and straining forward toward what lies ahead. I keep pursuing the goal in order to win the prize offered by God's upward calling in the Messiah Yeshua. Amen? Mm-hmm. Look at verse 12.
Verso 12.
It is not that I have already obtained it or already reached the goal. No, I've kept pursuing it in the hope of taking hold of that which the Messiah Yeshua took hold of me. Amen?
Amen.
He's talking about this walk into the desert with God.
Está hablando de este caminar en el desierto con Dios.
He's talking about after Hag Matzah.
Está hablando acerca de Hag Matzah.
He's talking about obtaining the goal.
Está hablando acerca de obtener el objetivo.
Did Israel obtain the goal after they got out of the Red Sea?
¿Será que Israel alcanzó el objetivo después de que salió del mar?
No,
de
they
los
still
juntos.
Had more time to go.
No, aún tuvieron más tiempo para seguir.
A new life of walking with God.
Una nueva vida de caminar con
That's what Paul is talking about to the Messianic congregation in Philippi.
De eso habla Pablo de la congregación mesiánica en Filipenses.
It's not a church.
No es una iglesia.
In Philippi, it's a Messianic congregation.
Es una congregación mesiánica en Filipo.
They were changing their lives.
Estaban cambiando sus vidas.
What he's talking about here in verse 12. Let's read verse 12 again.
Leamos el verso 12.
It is not that I've already obtained or already reached the goal. No. I keep pursuing it in hope of taking hold of that for which the Messiah Yeshua took hold of me. Amen?
Amen.
It's about determination.
Se trata de determinación.
Following the word of God in the world we live in is determination.
Seguir la palabra de Dios en el mundo en que vivimos necesita determinación.
It's about daily trials.
Se trata de pruebas diarias.
Anybody go through some trials this week?
Todos han pasado por pruebas esta semana.
That's what God wants you to go through.
Eso quiere que Dios pases.
Why does He want you to go through trials?
Porque Él quiere que pases por pruebas.
To see how good your determination
para
is.
Para ver cuán buena es tu determinación.
Determination shows a loving Father.
La determinación muestra un Padre amoroso.
And a giving Messiah.
Y un Mesías que da.
That you are willing to do things for Him.
Y que estás dispuesto a hacer cosas para Él.
Look at verse 14.
Verso 14.
Look at verse 14.
Verso 14.
I keep pursuing the goal in order to win the prize offered by God's upward calling in the Messiah Yeshua. Amen?
Amen.
Keep running the race.
Sigue corriendo la carrera.
What did Yeshua say in Luke?
¿Qué dijo Yeshua en Lucas?
9 verse 62.
9 verso 62.
What did he say, Frank?
¿Qué decía?
What did Yeshua say?
¿Qué dijo Yeshua?
Keep your hands on the plow.
Mantén tus manos en el arado.
Is that what he said, Danny?
Es eso lo que sí.
Is that what he said? Why? What happens if you don't, Dan? If you look back, you die. No, he didn't say that. What did Yeshua say, Tiffany? You won't be fit for the kingdom.
No serás apto para el reino.
Keep pursuing the goal, everybody.
Sigue persiguiendo el objetivo.
What is this upward calling that Shaul is talking about?
¿Cuál es esta llamada que habla Shaul?
The promised land.
La tierra prometida.
The promised land.
La tierra prometida.
That's when you got out of the ocean.
Si tú saliste del océano.
3,000 feet of water.
3,000 pies de agua.
I made it.
Lo hice.
I made it.
Lo hice.
And you come to the foot of the cross and you say,
y vienes al frente de la cruz y dices,
praise you, God.
Adorado, alabado sea el Señor.
Praise you, God.
Alabado sea el Señor.
That's what Paul's talking about.
Eso es lo que habla Pablo.
Pursuing the goal means following the commandments.
Alcanzar el objetivo significa seguir los mandamientos.
Because the pagans want you to follow their commandments.
Porque los paganos quieren que sigas sus mandamientos.
Hi, Frankie. Hello. Gabriel, you work in the city. It's getting warmer.
Tú trabajas en la ciudad. Está calentando.
You work in New York City.
Tú trabajas en New York.
They have that naked thing over there by where you work.
Tienen esa cosa desnuda por donde
all those women with the body paint on them, Gabriel.
Esas mujeres con la pintura de en el
somebody
cuerpo.
Left a pair of mirrored sunglasses here.
Alguien dejó un par de gafas aquí.
Pursuing the goal.
Alcanzar el objetivo.
Is choosing not to look.
Es escoger no mirar.
Pursuing the goal.
Alcanzar. El objetivo.
Means pursuing your upward calling.
Significa perseguir tu llamado supremo.
So you can win the prize.
Así puedes ganar el precio.
Turn to 1 Corinthians 9, please.
Vamos a 1 Corintios 9.
1 Corinthians 9.
1 Corintios 9.
Verse 24 to 27.
Verso 24 al 27.
1 Corinthians 9.
1 Corintios 9.
Verse 29. 24 to 27.
Verso 24 al 27.
1 Corinthians 9.
Primera de Corintios 9.
This part is about called running the race.
Esta parte se titula correr la carrera.
Run the race.
Correr la carrera.
If you got to the other side of the Reed Sea, what would you do?
Si pasaste al otro lado del Mar de los Juncos, ¿qué harías?
You got there and kissed the ground.
Llegaste ahí y besaste la tierra.
1 Corinthians 9, verse 24 to 27.
Primera de Corintios 9, versos 24 al 27.
Don't you know that in a race, all the runners compete, but only one wins the prize? So then, run to win. Now every athlete in training submits himself to strict discipline, and he does it just to win a laurel wreath that will soon wither away. But we do it to win a crown that will last forever. Accordingly, I don't run aimlessly, but straight for the finish line. I don't shadow box, but try to make every punch count. I treat my body hard and make it my slave so that, after proclaiming the good news to others, I myself will not be disqualified. Amen? Whoa! Look at verse 27.
Veamos el verso 27.
Oh man, Ashevitz.
Wow.
Let's look at verse 27.
Verso 27.
27!
Verso 27.
I treat my body hard and make it my slave so that after proclaiming the good news to others, I myself will not be disqualified. Amen?
Amen.
I will not be disqualified.
No seré descalificado.
How are you going to be disqualified from heaven?
¿Cómo voy a ser descalificado del cielo?
If you call the Sabbath Sunday, you're disqualified.
Si llamas al sábado, domingo, eres descalificado.
If you're eating a ham sandwich,
si estás comiendo un sándwich de jamón,
you're disqualified.
Estás descalificado.
If you're a homosexual,
si eres homosexual,
you are disqualified.
Estás descalificado.
If you are an adulterer,
si eres un adúltero,
you are disqualified.
Estás descalificado.
Major parts of the law. If you're into sorcery,
las partes mayores de la ley, si
like
estás
Frank
en la brujería,
said about his testimony the other day, he was a Satan worshiper.
Como dijo Frank acerca de su testimonio, era un adorador de Satanás.
You've now been redeemed.
Ahora has sido redimido.
You've now been redeemed.
Ahora has sido redimido.
Now treat your body hard.
Ahora trata tu cuerpo.
Proclaim the good news.
Proclama las buenas nuevas.
Walk in the commandments.
Camine en los mandamientos.
Look at verse 24.
Vamos al verso 24.
Don't you know that in a race, all runners compete, but only one wins a prize. So then run to win. Amen?
Amen.
That's what today is all about.
De eso se trata hoy.
You run to win.
Tú corres para ganar.
Each day you walk in the commandments of God.
Cada día caminas en los mandamientos de
Dios.
Because
it's not a sprint.
Pero no es una trotada.
It is a marathon.
Es un maratón.
How do you run to win?
¿Cómo es que tú corres para
Frank,
ganar?
Frank, how do you run to win?
¿Cómo es que corres para ganar?
How do you run to win? He's running to win.
Él está corriendo para ganar.
He's running to win.
Él está
How do you run to win,
ganar?
Everybody?
Seis,
uno, tres. Seis, uno, tres. Seis, uno, tres. That's how you run to win.
Así es como corres para ganar.
Look at verse 25.
Verso 25.
Now every athlete in training submits himself to strict discipline, and he does it just to win the laurel wreath that will soon wither away. But we do it to win a crown that will last forever. Amen?
Amen.
We got to train to get to heaven.
Tenemos que entrenarnos para llegar al cielo.
Strict discipline.
Disciplina estricta.
I don't like the way this beard looks,
no me gusta
Lord.
La manera que esta barba se ve.
The Lord said, I don't care what you think.
El Señor dice, no me importa lo que piensas.
I don't like the way my hair is totally covered, ladies.
No me importa cómo mi cabello está cubierto totalmente.
My wife is much prettier with her hair all down.
Mi esposa es más hermosa con su cabello
suelto. She used to pay $110, $120 to get her hair permanent every couple of months.
Pagaba $120 al mes para hacerse permanente en el pelo.
But now it's all covered.
Pero ahora está solo cubierto.
That doesn't look very sexy.
Eso no se ve tan sexy.
Well, that's right. It's not supposed to.
No se supone que debe ser así.
But when we go home,
pero cuando vamos a casa,
that's what it's for.
Ahí es cuando es.
That's what marriage is all about. Strict discipline.
De eso se trata el matrimonio.
Strict discipline.
Disciplina estricta.
I see that your beard is a little short.
Yo veo que tu barba es un poquito
cortita. I see your beard is slightly getting longer.
Veo que tu barba se está haciendo un poquito larga.
I see Danny's mustache is beginning to fill in.
Okay, el bigote de Danny se está comienza a llenar.
Wait, you got a beard? That was cold, man, but it's cool. David! No, nothing's happening there yet. Oscar! Rav Ed! I see, sir, you don't have a beard.
Yo veo que no tienes barba.
Moses, what's going on over there, man? Strict discipline, gentlemen.
Disciplina estricta.
We want our families to be good.
Queremos que nuestras familias sean buenas.
We want our families to be prosperous.
Queremos que nuestras familias sean prósperas.
We want our children to be obedient.
¿Quieres que nuestros hijos sean obedientes?
Then men, we must be the example for our children.
Entonces los hombres deben ser el ejemplo para nuestros hijos.
You want to have strict training.
Tienes que tener un entrenamiento estricto.
And that's what Beth Goyim is all about.
Y de eso se trata Beth Goyim.
I don't even know if the Mets won a game.
Ni siquiera sé si los Mets ganaron.
I don't know if the Yankees won a game.
No sé si los Yankees ganaron.
The NFL draft, I usually watch it, but I don't care. It was
no
a holy day.
No importa, eran los días santos. Siempre veo la NFL, pero eran los días santos.
Look at verse 26.
Vamos al verso 26.
Accordingly, I don't run aimlessly. look straight for the finish line. I don't shadow box, but try to make every punch count. Amen? Amen. Make every punch count.
Haz que cada golpe cuente.
What is he talking about?
¿De qué está hablando?
Not wasting energy.
No gastar la energía.
Pick your shots.
Toma tus, tus,
because if you're in a fight,
porque si estás en una pelea,
if you're in a fight,
si estás en una pelea,
Jorge, come here. If you're in a fight,
si estás en una pelea,
if you're in a fight, you don't want, what's Paul talking about?
Si no quieres, si estás en una pelea, ¿de qué habla Pablo?
You don't want to waste time. You don't want to go, you want to block. You want to go. You don't want to waste energy. You don't want to waste energy. You want to keep it going. You want to keep it going. You don't want to waste.
No quieres gastar.
Don't
energía.
Waste your days.
No gastes tus días.
Don't waste your days.
No gastes tus días.
It says in the word, teach us to number our days.
Dice en la escritura, enséñanos a enumerar nuestros días.
You don't know when you're going to die.
Tú no sabes cuándo vas a morir.
So don't waste 1 minute.
Entonces no gastes
un minuto. I was going to cover my head tomorrow, Lord.
Me iba a cubrir mi pelo mañana,
Señor. I was going to cover all my hair tomorrow, Lord.
Me iba a cubrir todo el pelo mañana.
You're running aimlessly.
Estás corriendo sin
run straight for the finish line.
Tienes que correr directo a la línea.
Make
final.
Every punch count.
Haz que todo golpe cuente.
Don't waste your energy.
No gastes tu energía.
Don't waste your days.
No gastes tus
make
días.
Make every movement count.
Haz que cada movimiento cuente.
Turn back now to Romans 6.
Vamos de vuelta a Romanos 6.
Romans 6.
Romanos 6.
Final scripture. Final scripture.
Final.
Final scripture.
Escritura final.
Romans 6, verse 4.
Romanos 6, verso 4.
Romans 6.
Romanos 6.
Verse 4.
Verso 4.
Last scripture.
Última escritura.
For the message.
Para el mensaje.
Through immersion into his death, we were buried with him, so that just as through the glory of the Father, the Messiah was raised from the dead, likewise we too might live a new life. Amen? Amen. The holy days remind us
los días santos nos recuerdan
that we have been set free.
Que hemos sido apartados.
The holy days remind us
los días santos nos recuerdan
that we went through the Reed Sea.
Que pasamos por el mar de los juncos.
Jew and Gentile as one family.
Judío y gentil como una familia.
That we might have a new life.
Así tendremos una nueva vida.
We all need to be Hebrews.
Todos necesitamos ser hebreos.
For we all need to cross over to the other side.
Porque necesitamos todos cruzar al otro lado.
What do you do with your new found freedom?
¿Qué haces tú con tu nueva libertad?
Do you sin some more so God can show you more mercy?
¿Pecas más para que Dios te muestre más gracia?
Here we are today.
Aquí estamos hoy.
Teach us to number our days, Lord.
Enséñanos a enumerar los días.
Do you leave Egypt?
¿Dejas tu Egipto?
Has it left your hearts?
¿Te ha dejado tu corazón?
Or did you leave Egypt?
¿O dejaste Egipto?
And Egypt never left you.
Pero Egipto nunca te dejó.
Amen.
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 Why don't we bow our hearts for one moment?
Inclinemos nuestros corazones por un momento.
Thank you, Lord, for your blessings today.
Gracias, Señor, por tus bendiciones de hoy.
Thank you, Lord, for your word.
Gracias, Señor, por tu palabra.
This word of encouragement.
Esta palabra de ánimo.
We ask you, Lord,
te pedimos, Señor,
to teach us to number our days.
Que nos enseñes a enumerar nuestros días.
We ask, Lord,
te pedimos, Señor,
that you would guide our hearts.
Que guíes nuestro corazón.
Allow Egypt to leave our hearts.
Permite que Egipto deje nuestro corazón.
And walk in his ways.
Y camine en sus caminos.
If you're out there,
si estás afuera,
and you've never made your first step toward the promised land,
y nunca has dado tu primer paso a la tierra prometida,
I'm going to say a simple prayer.
Voy a decir una oración simple.
That you should say.
Que tú debes decirla.
But meaning in your heart.
Pero decirla de corazón.
Yeshua is the Messiah.
Yeshua es el Mesías.
It's over in over 400 places in the Old Testament.
Está en 400 lugares diferentes en el Antiguo
Testamento. He's calling you today.
Te está llamando hoy.
He's saying cross over.
Está diciendo cruza.
Cross over.
Cruza.
Cross over.
Cruza.
I'm going to lead in a simple little prayer.
Voy a guiar en una oración muy simple.
That if you want to make that first step.
Que si quieres dar ese paso.
And say these words.
Entonces, di estas palabras.
But mean it in your heart.
Pero dilas de corazón.
Say, Lord.
Di, Señor.
I know I'm a sinner.
Yo sé que soy pecador.
But today.
Pero el día de hoy.
I want to cross over to the other side.
Quiero cruzar al otro lado.
I ask for your forgiveness, Yeshua.
Te pido perdón, Yeshua.
I ask you to wash me.
Te pido que me laves.
Clean me.
Que me limpies.
Make me something new.
Y que hagas algo nuevo de mí.
So I can cross over to be with you.
Así puedo cruzar a estar contigo.
If you've done that for the very first time.
Si has hecho esto por primera vez.
And meant it in your heart.
Y lo has dicho de corazón.
Then you are born again.
Entonces has nacido de nuevo.
But Yeshua said this.
Pero Yeshua dijo esto.
That if you don't profess me before man.
Que si no lo profesas delante de los hombres.
I cannot.
Él no puede.
And will not.
Ni tampoco.
Profess you before my Father and His angels.
Te profesará en delante del Padre y los ángeles.
So if you've done that for the very first time.
Si has hecho esto por primera vez.
Crossed over to the other side.
Has cruzado al otro lado.
In spirit and in truth.
En espíritu y verdad.
Lift up your hand so we can pray with you.
Levanta tu mano y oraremos contigo.
If you're hearing this on radio, television, or internet,
si nos estás escuchando en radio, televisión,
just
internet,
let us know so we can pray with you.
Déjanos saber y oraremos contigo.
In your name, Yeshua.
En tu nombre, Yeshua.
Amen.
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 Shalom. This is Messianic Rabbi Andrew Dinnerman. I would personally like to thank you for tuning in to The Remnant's Call each and every week. You can listen to the full message on our website, bethgoyim.org. If you have drawn closer to the King of Kings, learned more about Him today, we are blessed. If you are blessed by these messages, please consider a donation to our ministry. You can go to our website, bethgoyim.org. That's BETHGOYIM.org. And click on the donate button. You do not have to have a PayPal account to donate. All you need is a debit card. Once again, thank you very much for listening to The Remnant's Call.
If you have not taken your first steps to be born again, just ask God's help. Remember, it's His loving grace that has come to find you. No one is worthy or able to reach God, but God can reach us, and He's reaching out to you now. Just open your heart and let Him in. His arms are open, and the blessing of salvation and eternal life are waiting for you. Don't let it wait any longer.
Shalom. May the Lord bless you and keep you. May the Lord lift His face and shine upon you. May the Lord be gracious unto you and give you His shalom.
Shalom. My name is Messianic Rabbi Andrew Dinnerman, and I invite you to come to visit our congregation. If you are in the tri-state area, come out and visit with us on Shabbat. We are a congregation of Jews and Gentiles living as one in the Messiah Yeshua. BGMC is a place of true worship. The focus never wanders from the Hebraic roots of our faith. Beth Goyim is rooted in the Word of God from Bereshit through to the book of Revelation. Messiah's strong words against man-made tradition are carefully recorded in Matthew 7. That is the reason we only follow the straight-up instructions found in Scripture. Truly, the way, the truth, and the life. If you're looking for a deeper walk with Adonai, come out for our Tuesday evening Bible study called Messianic Torah Time. Come, spend a day with us on any Shabbat. We start at 11 a.m. with the sound of the ancient Hebrew shofar. Next, we offer our King praise and worship in English, Hebrew, and Spanish. After worship, we review the headlines in the previous week's news from around the globe, especially news from the Holy Land Israel. We don't just list the news headlines as current events, but we comb through the scriptures, searching for clues to understand what they mean, and then to help pinpoint prophetically our current position on Adonai's clock. After digesting all that modern information, we leave the world behind as we journey with our Adonai deep into His eternal word. Not with just one or two scriptures, but usually seven or more scriptures. The spiritual nourishment and the richness of His kingdom become accessible
to the ones who share this special time and seek them out. The day does not end there. Because Shabbat is so special to him, there is always so much more that our King desires to share. So instead of separating and leaving, we stay together as a family for potluck lunch and an afternoon study of our King's Word. We close the Shabbat together with the reading of the new week's parasha. That's the Torah portion. Even after those blessings, many of us just can't get enough. So the members bring prepared homemade foods to share while we all enjoy an uplifting movie together. If all that information is not quite enough, you can check out our website where you will find over 200 video teachings and biblical holy day studies. Under Messianic Torah Time, the Hebrew Roots button, you'll discover free studies on many, many different topics, including PowerPoint slide presentations. If Beth Goyim sounds like a place you'd love to visit, but you live outside the tri-state area, there is still a way to connect with us. We stream live on the internet on Tuesday, Thursday, and Shabbat. The website is www.bethgoyim.org. That's BETHGOYIM.org. Our phone number is 973-338-7800 or 978-2-YESHUA. That's 978, the number 2, Yeshua. Shalom.